It's American Hockey League action at the Hartford Civic Center tonight as the Rangers' top affiliate, the Hartford Wolfpack, take on the league-leading Manchester Monarchs. The top two clubs in the AHL's Atlantic Division going at it here tonight. Manchester leading the division and the league with 41 points. The Wolfpack 8 behind with 33. The Pack won the first meeting between these two teams 4-3 in Manchester this past Sunday. Hello, this is Bob Crawford, and I'll be joined again on the color analysis tonight by Hall of Famer and ex-New York Ranger Brad Park, and two great hockey teams on the ice here tonight. Brad, should be a spirited battle.
Well, it was. It was a week ago when Hartford beat Manchester in Manchester. Both teams got off to 9-0 records. The Wolfpack faltered, but Manchester has stayed strong all the way through.
The Wolfpack recently on a pretty good streak before a loss last night, and as it has been pretty much the last 2 years, a lot of it's come down to the fact that Jason LaBarbera has played real well.
Well, he's been a stellar goaltender. Set a record last year in the American League for shutouts, and this year he's been just dynamite with 4 shutouts so far. He's a big guy. He gets side to side. You'll notice he goes down, puts the paddle down, and he close in shots in front of the net. He's been a reason that the Wolfpack have had such a stellar year last year, and again a good start this year. So count on Jason LaBarbera to be stellar tonight.
LaBarbera uses his size so well, it's hard to get anything by him low, and very active in the crease as well. Right off the top of his crease there, cutting down the angle. LaBarbera with a 1.49 goals against average, that's best in the league, second in the league in save percentage. He's won 5 straight, and 3 of those shutouts have come in the last 4 games. And also key for the Wolfpack in this matchup tonight, Brad, two guys that we haven't seen yet in our MSG telecast, Garth Murray and Jeff Hamilton.
Well, both players, Garth Murray and Jeff Hamilton, coming off of injuries. Murray had a thumb injury, Jeff Hamilton had an ankle injury, but they are guys that can be key. Last year, Jeff Hamilton was dynamite for the Bridgeport Sound Tigers, but Garth Murray is a guy that stirs the pot. He likes to get to the net. He's not afraid to get involved and definitely not afraid to drop the gloves to make sure that things are going to go his way for his team. He's kind of a light heavyweight, like a Nicky Fittitu style player. He's going to stir the pot as much as he can.
Murray got into 20 games at the big club last year, and here's his one goal in the NHL.
Well, definitely Garth is not noted for his talent as a goal scorer, but he is a character guy, and the Rangers are looking for him to add that character at the NHL level. Jeff Hamilton, on the other hand, is such a talented guy, led the AHL most of last year in scoring until an injury, but he's a guy that can put the puck away from any place on the ice. A very deceiving guy, not big, but goes to the net very, very well.
This Hamilton's first goal of the year, sneaky little game winner from behind the net against his old club, the Bridgeport Sound Tigers, for whom he led the AHL in goals last year. Murray, you see a third round pick in 2001, real good sized guy at 6'2 and 215 pounds. And of Hamilton's 3 goals this year, they've all been game winners. He set a record in that category last year with 15. In the AHL. And the Manchester Monarchs, the opponent here tonight, Brad, they've done a lot with offense this year. They're really burning up the AHL scoring statistics.
Well, they are. This team has a lot of scoring potential. Bruce Boudreau, who's done smoke and mirrors the last few years with injuries, has these guys in this lineup. Mike Camilleri, Yannick Lehoux, number 2, Tom Kostopoulos, number 4. These guys can have great offensive production. Everything is coming together for them this year. They've had solid goaltender, but these guys, Camilleri, average definitely a point of a game. LeHoux has tremendous one-on-one capabilities of beating guys, and you got to watch out for those two guys.
On the Wolfpack side, you see the Wolfpack losing 2 of their guys out of the lineup with coaches' decisions a couple of times the last few games. Jamie Lundmark and Joseph Bolle, they're looking for more out of those guys.
Well, that's definitely true. You got to remember the Wolfpack got off to a 9-0 start. They've only won 16 of the last 15 games, but they were looking for point production. Jamie Lundmark, Joseph Bolle, who they really count on, were disappointing. The coach, Ryan McGill, says, hey, guys, sit down, think about it, come back strong.
Second meeting of the year between these two top teams in the Atlantic Division. The opening faceoff is next from the Hartford Civic Center as the Wolfpack try to continue their great home ice play. We'll be right back. Big divisional battle at the Hartford Civic Center tonight. Wolfpack head coach Ryan McGill not happy with his troops after a 3-2 loss in Providence last night. They had a lengthy meeting this morning where a lot was discussed. And Brad, it's going to be interesting to see how they come out tonight. They're set to drop the puck in the center circle. Referee Dan O'Rourke drops it down, and we're underway. It's dumped into the Hartford Wolfpack zone by Doug Nolan, who wrestles around with David Lifton. And right off the start here, we're going to get some rough stuff. Lifton with the takedown there. Now they're going to get back at it before finally falling to the ice again. Well, that didn't take long, Brad. The two players will be unpiled. Lifton and Nolan. And they'll be sent off to the penalty box area as Nolan just returns from a fairly lengthy injury absence. That comes just 9 seconds into the game. And there you see the smile on the face of Doug Nolan, looking to get involved right off the start here. And I'm sure Ryan McGill, a little happy with that in terms of having his team involved physically immediately at home as well. I don't think he was very happy with the lack of physical play last night against Providence, draw in the Wolfpack zone. And Dwight Helminen wins it from Matt Ryan. Ryan Hallwig has the puck. He'll throw it ahead toward Craig Weller, but it's broken up. Now Ryan Hallwig throws a big hit on Dan Welch, and a blast by Ken Jernander goes wide of the mark. Puck held in by Jeff McMillan. Jernander forechecking behind the net. Now Mike Weaver is hit, but he's able to play it away to center. And Hallwig, as he always is a real wrecking ball out there on this shift. The Monarchs will start from behind their own net, led by Tim Gleason. Welch will snap it in. The Barbara stops it off as the Monarchs go for a line change. McMillan with some real estate to work with, has a pass block. Here's Jeff Giuliano. Bumped by Weller. Giuliano carries on. Now the much bigger Weller takes the puck away from him. And it's tipped to center by Chad Wiseman. Chris Schmidt will go back to chase. And Adam Hauser very nearly played that puck in the restricted area, which would have been a delay of game penalty. Hauser hasn't lost all year in nets for Manchester. Jamie Lundmark spinning it toward Wiseman. He's hit by Schmidt. Now a centering feed just eludes Lundmark as Joseph Bolle threw it in front. Good work by Lundmark to keep it in. Wiseman can't get to it. Over on the near side, it's Joe Roulier. Can't slide it by Bolle. A good shift by this line. And we've got a whistle as one of the metal stanchions that holds up the glass has come out.
Well, that gives you a little bit of indication of everybody finishing their checks when the stanchions start dropping on the ice. And there's a look at Joseph Bolle, who's very quick getting from A to B. And he would noted for his offense, but has not been as productive as Ryan McGill and Nick Fetillo would like this year. But he's out there with Jamie Lundmark, and they can put some numbers up on the board.
As we referenced in our open tonight, both Bolle and Lundmark sat out a couple of games last weekend, and Ryan Hallwig got there really taking the body to the Manchester Monarchs as the rink crew gets that stanchion re-secured. Wolfpack won a pair of games last weekend with Bolle and Lundmark out of the lineup, one of which was that overtime victory in Manchester on Sunday. Dominic Moore on the draw here against Yannick Lahou. Moore out with Alex Giroux and Jeff Hamilton on this Hartford Wolfpack line. Hamilton trying to hold it in, and he does against Tom Kostopoulos. Taking it off is Dennis Grabeshkov. His lead is to Lahou. He's just able to slide it ahead to center, and Kostopoulos will skate into it. Kostopoulos, a long shot, pad save, rebound right in front, cleared away, but not out. Now it eludes Lahou, but it'll be kept in by Weaver. And he knocks Moore down. Puck played by Hamilton. But Moore can't wrap it up. Lahou partially fans on a shot, and Lawrence Nicolet will take it in. He rolls it towards Giroux. He takes a hit to clear it near the line, but he can't get it out. LaBarbera steps out. He'll try the near side. And jumping up to hold it in is Gleason to Kostopoulos. Kostopoulos looking to center. That's blocked by Lampman. Hamilton still can't clear. Here's a shot by Gleason, and that misses wide. Rebound to Hamilton. Once again, Gleason holds it. Long drive, tipped wide. Rebound fought for. And Nicolet is held up and knocked out. Nothing called. Now they will call a penalty. I didn't think that Dan O'Rourke was going to call it, but he does. And after a good shift of zone pressure, the Manchester Monarchs are going to be hit with a penalty.
There's not too much doubt about this as the puck moves to the corner. There's Nicolet, got a stride. There's a little hook right there by number 24, and that's Noah Clark. He's going to serve a two-minute minor penalty. The Wolfpack are going to get on the power play. Looks like they're using the unmarked line with Wiseman.
And right off the draw, here's Weller steaming into the offensive zone. Weller forced to a wide angle. Now he's hit behind the net by Gleason. He can't clear it past Lundmark. He's got Giuliano right on him. And Weller will have to retreat to center. His feed misses Lampman. And the Barber will set the table for him. First power play of the game for either side. The Pack power play has been pretty sharp as of late. Here's a long feed to Hamilton, but he can't get it deep in the offensive zone, and the Wolfpack will have to regroup. The Barbara stops it off for Lampman. He deals it to Lundmark. A forward playing a point on the power play. Offside is the call as Hamilton sent it to Wiseman.
Well, Hartford not being able to come up the ice on this power play very smoothly, as the Manchester Monarchs are doing a fine job of breaking the thing. One of the things that led that bad, Jeff Hamilton clearing the puck, putting it out to the point, and that was right on the stick of the Grabeshkov. Now what Hamilton's got to do is, anytime you're going to clear the puck, there's a spot about 4 or 5 feet inside the blue line, and that's what you aim for, about a foot and a half high, because even if the defenseman gets a leg on it, he can't control it with his pads.
Loose puck jammed at by McMillan. Now Bolle controls. His feed is to Nicolet. Trying to get it to Moore, but it was behind him. Held in by Bolle to Dominic Moore. He finds Giroux. He has it poked away by Roulier, but it's held in by Bolle. Bolle's pass intercepted by Schmidt. He hands it toward Roulier, and he'll clear it away for the Monarchs. The Barber looking to move the puck. Now he'll hand to Nicolet. Nicolet dropping it off to McMillan. He flips it ahead to Giroux. He can't get it deep in the offensive zone. Not much pressure to this point by the Wolfpack power play. And they'll have to start from behind their own net.
Well, Manchester forced him at the blue line. And that first pass has got to get through, and it's got to be on the tape.
Giroux keeps it alive against Gleason, but a feed is intercepted. And Kostopoulos has time. He'll fire it down the ring. Manchester in a change. Nicolet handing it up the wing toward Jed Ortmeyer, trying to step past Denis Grabeshkov. Grabeshkov knocks him down. Welch has the puck. And despite a big bump on him by Trevor Gillies, Welch is able to clear it away. The penalty is over. And the Wolfpack are called for a two-line offside pass.
Now that's a pretty good grinding line for the Wolfpack right here. Garth Murray playing center, Trevor Gillies on the left side, and on the right side, Jed Ortmeyer, known for his, you know, taking the body and playing hard and his defensive capabilities. But Ortmeyer chasing this puck down the end. Got to make sure he gets a hold of it, loses his balance. Not afraid to get in there and mix it.
Gilly sends it to center ice. Ortmeyer tipping it ahead, but it's grabbed off by David Steckel. Lampman for the Wolfpack has it poked away by Connor James, who's playing his first game of the AHL for the Monarchs, up from the ECHL. The Barbara stops it off for Lampman. He's unable to clear. Gillies gets tied up by Steckel. Now Murray back checking, loses it to Steckel. Gillies ties up Grabeshkov, but Gillies can't get it out. Here's Jake Taylor to Ortmeyer. He's knocked down by George Perils. Puck kept in by Steckel. His shot is blocked wide by Murray. Now a feed is intercepted by Murray, and he'll lift it away to center to Ortmeyer. A lot of the action's been in the Wolfpack end in the first 5 minutes of this game. Schmidt with a lead pass to Grabeshkov. He has it poked away by Bolle, but Bolle didn't see the puck. Schmidt now hands it off to Grabeshkov. He nearly had his pass intercepted by Lundmark. It's tipped in over the Wolfpack line. Weller battling with Giuliano. Wiseman takes it away. Has a feed block. It's loose on the doorstep. Now Mike Camilleri to his backhand, a big play by McMillan to block Camilleri's attempt. Puck kept in, and a centering feed finds Camilleri. He can't stuff it underneath LaBarber. And stick handling with it is Lundmark. He'll lead the Wolfpack out. Lundmark dumps into the offensive zone. Bolle will go into forecheck. And the puck comes to Lundmark. He looks to center. And it's tipped away from two Wolfpack players. Finally, Lampman gets a shot away, but that's blocked. And Bolle didn't see the rebound in time. Dustin Brown on left wing sets up Giuliano. Giuliano looking for a trailer, circles back, tries to dish it to Ryan. He overskated it. Kept alive by Giuliano. Now it's loose on the doorstep, and Nicolet holds it away from Ryan. And Nicolet will get it out of there to Wiseman, but he turns it over. And Peter Kanko dumps back in. Nicolette chased by Kanko. Alex Lundmark with a long lead right on the tip of Ternander. He's got Wiseman with him. Ternander fires a shot. The save is made by Hauser. Big pileup of the gold crease. And the puck is frozen on the best Wolfpack chance thus far. No score in the first. We'll be right back.
Well, when you got to get the puck out of your zone, you move it to the right guy. Jamie Lundmark threads a pass, sending Ken Jernander and Jad Wiseman on 2-on-1. Jernander takes the shot because he's the guy that's been given the shot by the defenseman. And Joseph Ballet, who was not on that play, taking the body.
Offensive zone draw for the Wolfpack. Down from the point is Taylor. He finds Helminen. And a spin away from LeHoux. Dwight Helminen out of the University of Michigan to Hallwig. Now Jernander gets hit, but the Wolfpack keep it alive. And once again, that stanchion has come out. A lot of activity in this building today as they had a concert earlier in the day, and the crew really has to work hard to get everything squared away in time for a 7 o'clock hockey game.
Well, especially the glass and the stanchion. One of the things, when they change the ice over from a concert, they leave the boards up, but they have to put in all the glass and all the stanchions. It looks like they're not going to mess with that piece. They're going to replace it entirely. It might just not be a good fit. Let's go back and look at that last save. There's Ken Jernander. You see the defenseman, Joe Royer, pulled off of Jernander, allowing him to get that shot. That's not a good play, because when a guy comes down with a stick in the center, you cannot let him slap the puck from inside the top of the circles. That's just it. If he finds a hole, it's in, because if a guy is slapping the puck from about 30, 35 feet out, and it's on a hole, there isn't a goaltender in the world that can move fast enough. So you might give him a wrister from there, but definitely not a slapper.
Kenny Jernander has struggled to score goals this year. He finally got his first of the year in a game on Wednesday night here at the Hartford Civic Center into an empty net. But at this point, almost any offense that Jernander tosses in is almost icing on the cake with all the rest of the stuff he gives you.
Kenny's such a hard-working guy. Game in and game out, he's going to give you his best effort. He's the guy that's the veteran on the team that shows leads by demonstration. He's a very smart player. He's got some good offensive skills. Defensively, he's very sound. And he's pretty versatile, too, because last year they used him a lot on defense, which surprised a lot of the scouts when they came to the game and saw Kenny Jernander back on the D.
I thought many of the nights he was on defense, he was the Pack's best defenseman. As the players get ready to
you just have
back to this.
You do get smarter as you get older.
As you see, we've got the top team in the AHL on offense against the top team on defense in the AHL here tonight. 4.3 goals per game. You haven't seen numbers like that in pro hockey in a few years.
No, this is very surprising. But Manchester, these young guys, and Yannick LeHoux out there right now at center, he can be a very dangerous player, and he's having a terrific year.
Here's a long drive that's right on net, and Hauser saw it all the way on the shot by McMillan, and Hauser will cover it up.
One of the things, Jeff McMillan had that shot from the point. There was no screen, there was no deflection, and when you get that shot, you want to make it about 8 inches high, because it's over the stick and it's on the pads. If it's about a foot and a half, it's going to hit the goaltender in the midsection, and that's where this shot gets up a little high and you don't get a rebound. But 8 inches, you'll get a rebound off those pads.
Hauser's a pretty big goaltender too, 6'2 and 194 pounds. Here's Gleason to Weaver. He's bumped by Murray, and a shot is deflected just wide by Ortmeier. A real crash line out here, as you talked about a second ago, Brad. Murray, Ortmeier, and Gillies, as they force Manchester into an icing. Three real big, tough bodies out there.
Well, three guys that will grind it out shift after shift. Right here, Murray wins the draw, and the shot goes to the net. It's tipped. Now, Garth's going to try and finish that check. The one thing about going in there with a lot of speed, if the guy moves about a foot and a half, you're going to find you got an empty space to hit. But don't, that does not deter Garth, believe me.
Face-off will be between Moore and Ryan.
That's kind of like, in basketball, they have the air ball, and when the guy moves, it's an air hit. You know, something like that.
The Wolfpack actually lost Lane Ulmer in that game Sunday in Manchester when Craig Weller went to hit Ryan, and Ryan stepped out of the way at the absolute last second, and Weller didn't realize that Ulmer was behind Ryan, and Weller ended up putting a pretty heavy shoulder check on his own man. Here's Moore. Snaps a shot, and it's kicked away by Hauser. The rebound to Roulier. And Welch with a lead pass just too far for Kankel. But Barber will swing it toward Weller. He's got Welch right on him. Now it's Peter Kankel. He sheds Moore's check. Now hand it off to Ryan before he gets knocked down by McMillan. Welch and Weller now tangle. Kankel loses the puck, but Hamilton falls down. Hamilton will get it again, and he scoops it out of there. Roulier controlling for the Monarchs. Now Welch fans in a dump in. It's gloved down by Nolan, but he loses it. In comes Wiseman, but Hauser's on his angle on Wiseman's shot, and Hauser will freeze it.
Wow, Wiseman going over and trying to lay a hit on number 21, Matt Ryan, knocks him off the puck right here. Now he goes in, looking for something, but doesn't have it, pulls the trigger, and into the midsection of Adam Hauser. That's Weller making a little bit of hitness. Let's fire him down a little bit.
Off the draw, Lifton has it. His shot is blocked. And the rebound carries to center. Lifton and Nolan back out of the penalty boxes after the encounter they had just 9 seconds into the game. Hallway causing traffic. Helmanen trying to jump on the puck, but he loses it to Steckel, former LA Kings first rounder. Now Taylor takes over. He's wearing that face mask to protect facial injuries he received in a practice accident a couple of weeks ago. And George Parros is shaken up. Play allowed to continue. Whistle finally blows. There was a collision between Parros and one of the Wolfpack players. And Parros struggles to get to his feet.
Well, he's dropping some blood as something came up and hit him up around the eye area. It could have been a stick down in the corner. We'll take a look at it right here as they're going in. He actually goes into the boards face first. And that's caused a little bit of damage to big George Parros, 6'5", 250. He just loses balance right there. And that's Kenny Jernander. And Kenny's a very, very clean hockey player. That's very unintentional for him just kind of finishing his check.
So Parros will have to go off for some repairs, and we get wholesale player changes for both sides as Jernander and his line head off to the bench. There's a good shot of Lundmark playing in his 10th game since returning from the Italian League.
That's a classic example when players, you see them go for repairs on their skates. If they get a nick on their skate, and that can happen when you're trying to make a little turn and that nick just kind of hits a rut and you lose your balance, and that's exactly what happened to George Parros.
Lundmark gets tripped down after he dug the puck free. Penalty coming against Manchester. Schmidt touches up the puck. It'll be a tripping call, and I got to think that Ryan McGill's pretty happy with the first few shifts that Lundmark's had in this game, Brett.
Well, I think so. Jimmy's been very involved. This is Chris Schmidt. He's kind of a Craig Weller player, very veteran player, who's played forward most of his career, but he trips Jimmy Lundmark right there as Lundmark goes in and takes the body. And Chris Schmidt playing defense, and he has not done that a whole bunch in the last few years.
Second power play for the Pack. Nicolet winding and firing. Hauser knocks it down. Rebound is loose, and Hamilton will pick it up. Hamilton spins it toward Wiseman. He's got Weaver right on him. Now Weller turning toward the front. Weller shooting, and that misses wide left. Rebound to Nicolet. His pass hits the referee. Hamilton keeps it alive. And he'll battle with Giuliano. Hamilton to Wiseman. Back for Hamilton. He tries to bang it off the side of the goal. Giuliano ends up in control. He's got Hamilton on his back, but Giuliano's able to clear. The Barber comes out to meet it. He's allowed to play the puck above the goal line, but as soon as it goes below that goal line, he can only touch it in that trapezoidal area behind the net. Noah Clark killing some time. Now Bale accepts a pass. Going the wrong way, he'll get turned around. Bale held up behind by Clark, able to push it in deep. Wiseman can't step past Brown. Now here's Lundmark with a snapshot. And Hauser gets that with a blocker, held in by Hamilton. He's bothered by Nolan. Now 2-on-1 down low. Here's Wiseman right on the doorstep. Can't stuff it in as Hauser went down to his knees and kept the lower portion of the net covered. What a quick developing chance there.
Great little play by Jeff Hamilton as he feeds Wiseman in front of the net. Lundmark takes a poor shot from the point, but look at that Hamilton. That little pass over, there's Wiseman. And that was from Belay from Hamilton. A nice little tic-tac-toe. There's Hamilton moving it to Belay. Blake gets a little backhand pass. Wiseman
You got to credit Hauser with just staying with that Wiseman while he had the puck on his stick.
Here's Laminada, Bale toward the front is Giroux, trying to one-handed on goal. Now Moore gets a try at it again. Hauser holds his ground, and he will freeze it. Lots of pressure on this Wolfpack power play, which has 43 seconds to go on it.
Now you get it. Wolfpack have really picked it up, as they're really doing great puck movement here on the power play. They do not get as strong shots on the net as they would like, but you know, this game has really changed since that Murray line started grinding it about 4 or 5 minutes ago.
That's a good point. They had a great shift, and that seemed to turn a lot of the momentum. Giroux has the puck. He had a hat trick a week ago tonight in Worcester in a 6-0 win. Lampman feeds it towards Giroux. He lets it go through to Bale. He's hit by Gleason. Moore trying to dig it free. It's loose in the crease, and only Hauser sees it. He will hang on, and now we'll get some shots exchanged right around Adam Hauser's crease. It started with Moore pushing with a Manchester player, and then Giroux got in the middle of it. Dominic Moore, the ex-Harvard Crimson, a guy who has a talent for getting the opposition a little irritated.
Well, Dominic gets in front of the net right here, and I think it's either Weaver or Kostopoulos right here as he tries to push it. And there's a push by both of them. That's Kostopoulos there, Weaver on the other end, trying to establish territorial rights on this power play for the Wolfpack. Another look at it, and Hauser just covers it, and a little pushing, shoving, whacking. Hey, you watching that, ref?
Looks like Bale got the only penalty out of that, so.
That was that little slash behind the net, and the referee, Dan O'Rourke, whistled Bale off. So it looks like we're gonna be 4-on-4 for about 25 seconds.
After that, it'll be a minute 35 of power play for Manchester, which will be their first man advantage of the game. Doug Nolan is hit by Hawick. Now away comes Ryan with a puck. Rookie out of the Ontario Hockey League. It's fended off by Nicolet. Now Lampman is pressured. Ryan turns toward the front, but Nicolet is able to hook it away from him, and out comes Hamilton to Ryan Hallwick. He's forced wide by Roulier. Now he gets back toward the middle. Hallwick shoots one, blocked by Nolan. Rebound to Hallwick as Manchester goes to a power play, and the goaltender Hauser has been spilled, and Nicolet has lost his helmet. Roulier stares at Nicolet. In comes Nolan as well.
Oh, Ryan Hallwick dancing with the puck. Nicolet goes to the net, taking Joel Roulier with him. Does not get the shot up right here, gets blocked, but look around the net. Hauser grabbing a hold of Nicolak, tearing his helmet off. Another look at it, Ryan Hauser, a little outside, inside move. Shot, the puck does not get to the net. Hauser outside the crease, and Nicolak bumping him. I mean, that's perfectly legitimate. The goaltender's gonna come outside the crease and run into you. No penalties called.
So they'll get the net re-secured, some housekeeping done on the ice next to Hauser's crease. Bruce Boudreau, veteran head man of the Monarchs, really has Manchester off to an unbelievable start this year.
Well, I give him a lot of credit. I mean, the injuries that Los Angeles have had the last 3 years has forced him to use smoke and mirrors to have a competitive hockey club, and he has done that. And the crowds in Manchester have warranted that. But this year, when he's got all the players and not having to lose them up to Los Angeles, he's been terrific.
Monarchs control as they set up the power play in this scoreless game. Yannick Lehoux, the second leading scorer in the AHL, playing one of the points on the power play. This pass misses Brown, and it went untouched, so there will be an icing call against the Manchester Monarchs.
Now, for you viewers that have not familiar with the American Hockey League, you notice that the lines, the blue line, the red lines, are all 2 feet this year, which increases the passing area, which increases the neutral zone. And it's, not bothering me too much. You know, it doesn't bother me a whole bunch. They're a little bit wider where they're normally a foot wide. Then you got to figure, if they're that wide, right, how can a guy go offside? Like, you can't see it?
certainly can't say that you didn't see it, that's for sure. It's interesting, now I go into rinks that have the old style blue lines that are just a foot wide, and it looks weird to me. I'm so used to seeing this configuration. Now Ortmeier blocks a pass, and Camilleri just beats his old college teammate back to the loose puck. And now Camilleri will have to set up in behind his own net. Camilleri, not a very big guy, but a great goal scorer. A Monarch pass doesn't connect. McMillan with plenty of time. But the puck hits the referee and stays in the zone. Here's a shot from the point by LaHoo. That's blocked. Rebound. Tipped at by Moore, but he can't get it out. Kostopoulos looking to center. Weller spins him around. LaHoo is there as well. Now Wiseman takes control, and he flips it between the point men and down the ice. Out comes Hauser to dish it to Camilleri. Now it's LaHoo. Cross ice to Gleason. His lead pass is blocked by Murray. Camilleri is unable to feed it to Brown. It gets wrapped up by Lifton and Murray. Now it's wedged back into the Wolfpack zone. Taylor will head back. He whips it hard around the boards, but it stays in the zone. Gleason leading it over to Ryan. His shot is blocked by Taylor. Bolle out of the penalty box. Nobody can find it. Oh, and a big hit by Brown on Helminen. Here's Brown with a puck. Can't step around, lift it. Now Murray loses his stick, but he has the presence of mind to kick it to Helminen. And he skies it just over Weaver's head. Back goes Ryan with a long lead pass. It looked offside, and it was. And play is stopped. We'll return to the Harvard Civic Center in a moment with the game still scoreless.
Now let's take a look at Dwight Helman trying to corral a puck. It's run over by Dustin Brown. Brown gets the puck back, and David Lifton does a great job of just taking him out, making sure that he can't get to the net with the puck. Garth Murray heads up, little kick pass.
Moore and Ryan on the draw. Nicolette now banging with Kanko. Giroux pokes at it. Moore gets hit. And Nolan will grab control to Mike Weaver. His pass is knocked away from Ryan. Moore looking to feed it toward Hamilton, but that doesn't work. Lampman chases the sliding puck. He's flushed out by Welch. Now it's Nicolet. Hamilton lets it go through up the wing, but Schmidt cuts it off. And he'll float it back in. Nicolet to Hamilton. He can't whack it past Schmidt. Long shot through traffic goes into the midsection of LaBarbera. And he'll hang on.
Now LaBarbera having a little problem as Dan Welch was in front of him along with Bryce Lampman. As this puck comes through, he sees it at the last second and LaBarbera corrals it.
So there'll be a faceoff in the Wolfpack zone. There's Jason LaBarbera, the fifth year pro, and Schmidt the forward, and Manchester captain playing defense here tonight. We talked about Drenander doing that a bit for the Wolfpack last year. We got a penalty called. Off the faceoff, it's going to be a hook, and that's going to send the Hartford Wolfpack to their third power play of the first period.
As the puck moved out and the Wolfpack were proceeding up ice, we had a little hook going. It looks like Connor James, number 20, right there, hauling down his man. He can't do that unless he's got the puck. Here's a look at Dominic Moore trying to move forward, taking a little bit of body contact. It doesn't matter who you are, where you are. There's a lot of big bodies out here.
So James's first mark on an AHL score sheet is a penalty. And Nicolet will set things up for the Hartford Wolfpack. Pass goes behind Lundmark, but he's able to pick it up. Long cross ice feed, misses a couple of teammates. And that'll result in an icing against the Wolfpack.
Now that last breakout, Nicolet pass to Lundmark was behind him. And one of the things that Jamie Lundmark did was he's a little bit too far ahead. And basically what Nicolet had to do was kind of thread that puck. If he'd been back about 5 or 6 feet, it wouldn't have been a thread. And they're talking about that right now. And I think Lawrence Nicolet saying, Jamie, hold on, let me suck the guy into me, and then I'll lay it and make sure I can get in front of you.
Lundmark wins the draw. Now he'll drop back to one of the point positions. And Nicolet carries the mail. Here's the lead up the gut to Hamilton, to Wiseman down the wing. He drops it off to Weller. Weller looking for an opening, held up by Roulier. Now he leaves the puck behind the net. Roulier looking to clear it, but he can't get it by Nicolet. He's unable to get it deep, though. And Kostopoulos sends it just too far for Camilleri. Back goes Lundmark. And he will drop it again to Nicolet. Back to Lundmark with a left wing lead to Wiseman. He can't step around Weaver, but he maintains control of the puck. Hamilton spinning back. Now feeds it to Wiseman. Back to Hamilton. Firing one. Hauser the save. Rebound deflected off of Weller. And Hauser stayed with it.
Now Hauser getting a little bit lucky there as the big heavy slap shot by Hamilton bounces off him, hits Craig Weller on the rear end and almost goes behind him. There's the slapper right off of Weller. He couldn't find it. He was tied up with a defender in front. First of all, he puts the hook right there on the defender. Now watch, this is where you got to get your stick free. And Weller allows himself to get tied up. Now good play by Mike Camilleri coming back and helping out.
Weaver sends it in behind the net to Gleason. He's got time and he'll clear it all the way down. LaBarbera will stop it and wait for Lampman, third year defenseman. And his feed is on the stick of Giroux to McMillan. Weaver will chase it down for the Monarchs. He gets spun around, maintains control. And Weaver will slap it right back down.
Mike Weaver, nice little acquisition for the Monarchs. Played in the Thrasher organization, played a number of games for the Atlanta Thrashers the last couple of years. Smart, small defenseman. Good
and
to the puck.
LaBarbera comes out to work it away from Welch after Welch had stolen it. McMillan can't find Moore with a pass. Roulier sends it toward the goal and it hits Lampman's stick and goes wide. Lampman battling with Welch. Welch will track it down and he drops it to Schmidt, who will kill some time. And as Roulier dumps it in, that'll do it for the Hartford Wolfpack power play. Teams back to full strength. Hallwig does a good job to control it and moves into the offensive zone, but his shot hits Schmidt and goes over the glass. We'll return to Hartford momentarily. There's no score.
Now the game of hockey is a learning process. Ryan Hallwig has somebody on the right side. The defenseman stands up on that side and he does not use him. Boy, what was he looking at? You don't score on slappers from the blue line in pro hockey. Mighton Jr., but not here.
Ternander pokes it toward Helman and he steps past Nolan. Helman in centers one and it just gets through Hallwig, kept in by Lifton. He'll throw it in front and Helman was tied up just enough by Grabeshkov so he couldn't bang it home. Taylor blasting it right back in. There's going to be a penalty here. And Hallwig gives Nolan a bump. Grabeshkov chasing down the loose puck and the penalty's going against the Wolfpack. Another big hit by Hallwig as Hauser goes to the bench for the extra attacker. Nolan doubles back. Leaves it for Grabeshkov. And Lehu had to let that go through, or it would have been a two-line pass. Lifton finally touches up. Some staring after the whistle. And a cross-checking call is being signaled.
Looks like Jake Taylor is proceeding to the box for a cross-check. Down in the Manchester end, we're going to take a look at it. Taylor's going to shoot the puck in here. And he gives Noah Clark a shot on the back. Boys, can't we talk this out? I guess not.
Looked like some mutual stick work there, but Taylor's going to be the man sitting in a sin bin. And the Monarchs win the draw. Grabeshkov feeding it to Lehu.
That's profiling, you know. If there's two guys pushing, the big guy's going to get the penalty.
Kostopoulos looking for somebody to get open. Lehu fires LaBarbera. Big save. Big scramble off the rebound, and it's clear but not out. Now Moore will race to center, trying to get by Grabeshkov. Moore looking to get a step. Moore pokes it on goal, and he forced Hauser to make a big save, and a penalty is being called against the Monarchs. What a sequence there as LaBarbera made a big save. And the Wolfpack generated a great shorthanded chance. Now Kostopoulos and Nicolet are going to throw down the gloves.
Now they're squaring off, and this is going to be a dandy because Lawrence Nicolet is a mean little tiger. He can go. Kostopoulos is jumping in there, grabbing on.
And Nicolet goes down. Kostopoulos will try to hammer one in on him before the two linesmen, Jim Briggs and Marty Demers, jump in. Nicolet with another active game thus far here tonight.
I'll tell you what, we're going to see this little breakaway right here as Grabeshkov does a great job of crowning Dominic Moore. Now watch him reach in here. When they get down the goal, he's going to reach in and one hand lift the stick of Moore. Right there, that one little reach in and lift the stick means Moore can't get two hands on the stick for the shot. He comes down here. Look at that little reach. What a great defensive play by Denis Grabeshkov.
Although he did pick up a penalty for that.
Yeah, I can't see where the holding was. I mean, it was the play was over. Moore could get a one-hand shot, but a nice little move by Grabeshkov. I see that left hand come around, but he did not. He put it in front of him, but did not pull him back. But that does not matter to Dan O'Rourke, as the Wolfpack are going to gain another power play.
That comes just 24 seconds into the Manchester Monarchs man advantage. Grabeshkov, another good young prospect for the Kings. 18th overall pick in the 2002 entry draft. Still just 21 years old.
I like this young guy. I think he's a very, very talented offensive player. Good defensive skills, as we just saw. They've got some nice defensemen on this team. They're up and coming. I like Tim Gleason, Dennis Grabeshkov, Mike Weaver, still young. And those are the guys that I think Los Angeles are looking. They might be able to move up and give them that depth in that area. But Dominic Moore is not a slow skater. And he had a step on Grabeshkov. So he did one heck of a job getting back and making sure that Adam Hauser, who also did a pretty good job because he stayed with that one-handed flip by Dominic Moore.
As you saw on the scoreboard there, the Monarchs have actually picked up two penalties here. I don't know if somebody was yapping a little bit too much there about the call on the part of O'Rourke, but Camilleri went down the runway to the locker room, and just like that, it's a Wolfpack power play, 4-on-3. Jernander running things from the point to Hamilton. Back to Jernander again to Hamilton. Hamilton shooting. No, he decided to fake. He's got it back. Now he'll fire. That's blocked. Rebound jammed at by Lundmark, but he can't put it in. Now a feed is blocked as Lundmark tried to get it back to Hamilton, and the Monarchs clear it away.
Well, Lundmark having to deal with a bouncing, rolling puck as the puck rebounded off of Hauser.
Here's Jernander handing it off toward Hamilton. Hamilton cutting in, fakes a shot. Now Lundmark has it. Lundmark looking for a seam. I'll drop it back to Hamilton. Hamilton takes the slipper, and that's tipped up in the air and out of play by Schmidt.
Oh, big Chris Schmidt reaching out and deflecting that shot by Jeff Hamilton. Had the big high windup, took him too long to get it down. Right here, he moves it down to Lundmark. Now he's looking for something over on the far side. That's the wrister, and that was a rolling puck that Lundmark had trouble corralling. They're looking in front, Joseph Ballet doing a little dance in the front, trying to screen Hauser. But no shots are coming through. Good spot to be. He's right in position for a rebound, but that puck does not get there.
Here's Hamilton cutting in. Hamilton shoots. Hauser, the save on the rebound, just skips away from Giroux. Now it's Hamilton again. Hamilton feeds it to the far side. Now a feed goes under the stick of Giroux as Lampman fed it through. Hamilton gunning a blast, and Hauser gets a pat on that, kept in by Giroux. Giroux holding and looking. Now I'll drop it back to Jeff Hamilton. Hamilton doesn't shoot. Here's a cross slot feed, and Giroux scores! Nice puck movement there. And Lampman found Giroux for Giroux's team best ninth of the season.
Now, definitely some good puck movement by the Wolfpack as Hamilton gives it a fake pump, slides it over to Lampman, who finds Giroux on the near side. Good tic-tac-toe passing under Alexander Giroux, moving it right back here to Hamilton. Now he's going to give it a pump fake before he passes it right there. Bing, bing, and thank you very much. Hauser, because it looked like Hamilton was having the big slapper, got out to the top of the crease, and that kind of froze him. Right here, Hamilton fakes it. Hauser gets the top of the crease. Now he can't get back to that right post. And Giroux, Alexander Giroux, makes it 1-0 on a power play goal.
We'll have a 4-on-4 situation now for 22 seconds before the Pack go back to the power play. Taylor's still in the box. When he gets out, there will be time remaining on Camilleri's penalty. Giroux gets the goal, his ninth of the year on a power play at 18:37 from Lampman and Hamilton. Now Bale knocks Gleason down. Bale tracking the loose puck. Gets wrapped up. Out of the box comes Taylor, the Wolfpack, back to a power play. Inside the final minute of the first, Bale has it to Weisman, and his shot goes just wide. Kept in by Jernander. Looking down low, snaps it at the goal, and Hauser will glove that, and he holds for a whistle.
You know, going back to that power play, Bob, one of the things that Jeff Hamilton did on the near side when Lundmark was out there being a right-handed shooter, Hamilton was shooting blocker side three times in a row, which meant there's no catching glove on the blocker side, which means there's going to be a rebound, and Lundmark, being a right-handed shot, has a good opportunity to get to that puck. If it's by design, it's a pretty good play. If it's by accident, do it again, boys.
Wolfpack with 9 seconds still to work with on the power play, and they'll get an offensive zone draw here. Helminen against Schmidt. Helminen knocked down, tries to one-hand it in front, can't do so. Puck still alive. Murray trying to get to his forehand, but it's finally cleared away by Giuliano. And the Wolfpack get one goal on all those power play situations. Can't do any further damage. They're back to full strength. Weller for the Pack. Looks for his partner McMillan, and he finds it. McMillan parachutes it for the Manchester line. Now Weller gets hacked at by Brown. Coming back to get it is Dwight Helmanen. His feet too hot for Hallwig to handle. And that's going to just about do it for the first period of play. So after a long scoreless run, the Wolfpack get a power play goal. Pretty good period for them overall, 16-6 in shots on goal.
Well, kind of a dominant period shot-wise, but you'll have to like the way that the Wolfpack rebound. I think the first 4 or 5 minutes, they struggled a little bit. The energy line of Garth Murray, Trevor Gillies, and Jed Mortimer came out, banged some bodies, everything picked up. They did make out on the power plays, and definitely that penalty to Camilleri gave them a 4-on-3, and they capitalized for that goal lead.
So it's a 1-0 Hartford lead after one. We'll be joined by Bryce Lampman next. That's to Barry, Joe, and all the gang, and hope they're having a great time here tonight. And a pretty entertaining first period. A lot of special teams play.
Well, there was 6 power plays for the Wolfpack, and they capitalized on a 4-on-3. On the other hand, it was not so gracious for the Monarchs. They had 2 power plays, 0-for-2. But, the Monarchs came out a little stronger in the first 5 minutes. The Garth Murray line with Gillies and Ortmeier started to grind. And you just saw the tempo of the Wolfpack pick up. And, you know, you can see them start to carry the play a lot more to Adam Hauser, the goaltender.
There's Jason LaBarbera, who's looking for his 6th straight win, which would tie a franchise record that he has already tied once this year. LaBarbera won his first 6 starts of the season, allowing a total of just 5 goals in the process. A lot of the action was at the other end of the first period with all those power plays. The shot 16-6 in favor of the Wolfpack.
Well, one of the things the goaltenders, you know, they started a game, they anticipate a lot of shots. They start to not get as many shots as they want, but they maintain that focus. You really have to do it. And the goaltender does not know how the game's going to turn out, but anytime a goaltender has success, he always credits the guys in front of him.
That goes Roulier to pick it up for Manchester, pressured by Helmanen, but Ryan helps out for the Monarchs. That's off of Kanko's glove, and Taylor will stuff it right back in. Hauser steps out to set the table for Nolan. He gets bumped by Hallwig, who has a lot of marks on the hit chart by the time every game is done. He throws his body into Nolan there again, but Nolan finds Roulier. Here's a lead that bounces away from Ryan, but it goes deep in the Wolfpack zone. Taylor drills it up the boards. Leeson trying mightily to keep it in, but he just missed on it. It'll be offside.
Now, wrap around by Jake Taylor trying to move the puck out. And, Tim Gleason trying to get over the boards. Not only trying to go over the boards and stop, but also keep the puck in. Did not do it on that occasion. Nick Petillo having a little discussion with Jake Taylor, giving him his options. And that's part of coaching, as when he's dealing with a lot of young defensemen, is giving them options, reminding them what their options are when they're going back to get that puck.
Nicky loves working with those young players. Here's a backhand shot by Steckel. LaBarbera makes the save, and he stopped the rebound try by Perros as well. Big tie up behind the net. Now it's worked loose by James. Big Leeson, his one-timer is way wide. It almost decapitated Lundmark. And the whistle has blown. A penalty upcoming here against the Wolfpack. And over goes Perros to hit Wiseman. And now we got another fight going. This time it's Weller and Perros.
Craig Weller taking some exception to the late hit by Perros as he hit Wiseman just after the whistle. First order of business, get the helmets off so you don't hurt your hands as much.
Pretty much a wrestling match thus far. Perros, one of the few guys on the ice who's bigger than Weller. Perros, an ex-Princeton Tiger. Yeah, I don't think they do that in the dining halls of Princeton, do they?
That's an Ivy League takedown, in my opinion.
The bench fired up over that one. And those two guys will head out.
Now we'll have to see what the penalty call is, as this was after the fact, right in front of the net. That looks like a pretty good call. I think it's going to go against Craig Weller for taking David Steckel down. Steckel did not have the puck. Here's Weller getting into it. Now, once, you know, it depends on when a melee starts. Some guys will grab on, some guys will stand back. This occasion, both Weller and George Peros grabbing in. This is a pretty good save by LaBarre here as the puck came to him. That was Peros with a little backhand. LaBarre, I got the fumble mojo.
LaBarre.
Yeah, there you go. Anyway, nice save, Jason.
You see Peros in there already with the bandage above his eye. He got knocked into the boards in the first period and ended up getting nicked up for stitches. And it's funny how the guys look up at the scoreboard for the replay of their fights when they're sitting in the penalty box, critique their form. And it is going to be a power play here for the Manchester Monarchs. Their third of the game as the Wolfpack end up with the extra penalty. Camilleri has his pass for LeHoux, deflected by Jernander. It goes off of Jernander. Now to play, that's a bad break for the Wolfpack as it'll result in a face-off closer to the pack net.
Now Mike Camilleri controlling the puck off the draw, end up out of the point. Had a little time, but he hit Jernander on the skate.
Off the draw, Lampman has control, and he'll slap it down the rink. Camilleri will head back, the AHL's leading scorer. He spent significant time in the NHL with Los Angeles his first 2 years. LaBarre stops the dump in. He'll look to clear himself. Oh, he got it too high. That's going to be a delay of game penalty. Not what LaBarre wanted to do there. And the Wolfpack are going to be two men short for a minute 31.
Now, LaBarre having a good job of getting out and getting a hold of that puck. But most goaltenders want to shoot it off the glass. And, you know, one of the things that you can do, and you really look for the boards about a foot and a half off the boards instead of going that high. And if you can hit that, there's a Coke sign over by the right boards there. And if you can hit that Coke sign about a foot and a half, no defenseman can control it with their shin press.
Grabeshkov for Manchester on the 5-on-3 to Camilleri. Over to Clark. Back to Mike Camilleri. Here's Grabeshkov. To Camilleri. Back to Grabeshkov. He sends it down low to LeHoux. He'll center one and it goes through the slot. Held in by Clark to Camilleri. Takes the shot, Clark has it. Back to Camilleri. Grabeshkov, the defenseman. Camilleri, a one-timer blocked by Jernander, right back to Camilleri. Now it's Clark to Grabeshkov. Grabeshkov back to Camilleri, sends it toward LeHoux. It's out of his reach, but he'll recover it. McMillan can't hassle him enough. Here's Grabeshkov's drive. LaBarre the save, and Brown whips the rebound wide. Held in by Clark. Back to Grabeshkov. He walks in, shoots. LaBarre knocks it down. And McMillan buries Brown with a hit. And Jernander will get hit up high by Grabeshkov as he clears it. A penalty being called here again against the Wolfpack. Despite the fact that Jernander got hit up high, here's LeHoux carrying the puck. Delayed penalty situation. Extra attacker out for Manchester. And LaBarre freezes the puck off a drive by Clark, and the Wolfpack are really in tough now. A high sticking call with 23 seconds still left on Weller's penalty and 53 seconds on a penalty to Ortmeier.
LaBarre facing lots of rubber here. Grabeshkov finding the hole, getting it through, and that's been one of the things that the Monarchs have been doing well. There's a little bit of a high hit, but there's a penalty called right there, and I'm not sure if it's going to be this one in front on this hit by McMillan on... Who's that? That's Dustin Brown.
No, it's going to be Jernander going off here.
What happened when Grabeshkov stood up and made the hit? Jernander followed through and hit Grabeshkov while he was off balance. And that means we got a slew of penalties up there. Weller's got 23 seconds. Ortmeier's got 53. And now Jernander's got right here. There's the stand-up hit. There's the Jernander. That was actually Lampman giving him a little shot. But Jernander may be getting called for that.
So Jernander's penalty won't even start until the 23 seconds remaining in Weller's extra minor, which is being served by Giroux, elapse.
Well, we had a timeout called, and I think it was called by the Monarchs as Bruce Boudreau has called his players over to diagram what he wants happen on this 5-on-3.
Clearly he didn't like the last 5-on-3 sequence.
Well, he didn't. One of the things that, you know, he's down a goal. It's a great opportunity. He's going to have a 5-on-3 for at least 53 seconds because once the 23 expires on Weller, the Jernander penalty will kick in.
And Moore broke his stick on the faceoff. Grabeshkov to Camilleri, holding and looking. Now here's LeHoux. Throwing it across the slot. It's tipped away, held in by Clark to Grabeshkov. He holds and looks. Gaveshkov, the Camilleri, and he scores. There was another penalty coming against the Hartford Wolfpack, and Nicolet spills Brown after that goal went in. Manchester ties it, and it looks like there's going to be another penalty.
Wow. This is going to get real confusing because Lawrence Nicolet, before that goal went in, another penalty was called for a high stick in front of the net, which means Nicolet is either going to serve his penalty or it's going to get waived. But he was headed to the box. Here's the pass going out. Watch in front of the net. Right there is the high stick. Now it comes back, and this is Grabeshkov finding the area, looking, moving over for the one-timer. There's Camilleri, low stick side on Libera. As this puck found the hole, another look at it, that's the pass through. Gonna move out to the point, and this is right here where Grabeshkov and Camilleri are gonna switch sides. Now watch in front, a great one-timer stick side.
Camilleri, a great goal scorer in this league. Watch in front as Nicolet was battling with Dustin Brown. That's where the penalty comes. There's a shot to the chops, and then once again, you see the head of Dustin Brown snap back. Wolfpack trying to make life miserable for the opponent in front of the net. And Ryan McGill will talk to O'Rourke here. The goal, Camilleri from Grabeshkov, and Clark Camilleri ups his league-leading goal total to 21 in 24 games.
This is going to be another 5-on-3. 32 seconds left in Ortmeier's penalty. Then it will kick in to the 2 minutes to Nicolet. So it'll be a 5-on-3 for about 2 minutes for sure.
Camilleri feeds it down deep to Clark. Drops it back to Camilleri. Over to Grabeshkov. Patient with the puck now to Clark. Noah Clark back to Grabeshkov. He shoots. And the rebound is fired home by Clark after LaBarbera was hassled by Brown. And two goals lickety split, both on the power play for Manchester, and they've turned a 1-0 deficit into a 2-1 lead.
Now 5-on-3s are going to kill you. 4-on-3s, 5-on-3s. Noah Clark getting a good rebound as the puck moves out. Grabeshkov along the ice, low shot right on Noah Clark's stick, and he makes no mistake. Another look at it. Boy, I tell you, that couldn't have come on a stick any better off of the pad of Jason LaBarbera.
That's the eighth of the year for Clark. It's still a two-man advantage. Minute 27 now left on Jernander's penalty. A minute 50 on the minor to Nicolet. Camilleri to Brown. He'll whip it around. It deflects toward the front. Taylor jumps on it, and he clears it off the glass and down the rink for the Wolfpack. Out comes Hauser. He'll hand it off to Grabeshkov. Camilleri, who scored the first one. Drops it off to Grabeshkov. Brown setting a screen in front. Camilleri to LaHoo. He holds and looks. Here's Camilleri's drive. LaBarbera, big save. Rebound again to Camilleri. Dropping back. Now it's LaHoo holding. Has his pass blocked by Lifton. Lifton can't whack it out. Now Clark hands back to Yannick LaHoo. 38 seconds of the two-man advantage. Camilleri waiting. Hands it over to LaHoo. Back to Camilleri. One-timer high and wide. Rebound to Lifton after Taylor got knocked down and Lifton able to clear. Out comes Hauser feeding to Camilleri. He shovels it to Clark. And we're going to have another penalty here. Whistle blows.
I'm not sure what's going to get called here. It looks like the referee is signaling towards the bench. Looks like it's a bench minor pointing at Grabeshkov. It was over by the boards. Watch over by the boards right there. Grabeshkov gets knocked down and then gets halted. This could looks like almost too many men on the ice because he could not get to the bar, to the bench quick enough. This is a shot that goes over the net by Camilleri. That puck was not in the wheelhouse. It was probably too far in front of him, and he shanked it over the net. Well, we're seeing a little bit, for two polished teams, we're seeing a little lot of lack of discipline here. That's why we have all these penalties.
Right now, it's still a 4-on-3 for Manchester. Ryan looking for somebody to get open. Here's a drive by Gleason, and that's tipped wide. Rebound to Schmidt as the penalty to Jernander gets set to expire. Jernander out of the penalty box. It's now a 4-on-4. And the puck will be picked up by Ortmeier. He can't stick it away from Ryan. Now Gleason moves back in his own zone. Wolfpack led 1-0 coming into this second period. It's now 2-1 as a raft of penalties caused the Monarchs to be able to score a couple of 5-on-3 power play goals, and the play is now called down as the Wolfpacker judged guilty of icing.
Now Bryce Lamman shooting it down, looking for a change. But the Wolfpack very, very fortunate. They could be a little bit down 2 goals here by Barbara being stellar in the net on those one-timers, which are very hard for goaltenders to pick up. A couple of guys taking, lack of discipline penalties have put the Wolfpack, who led 1-0, behind 2-1 here in the second period.
Wolfpack control the draw. They're about to go on a power play, believe it or not. Wiseman starting it ahead as Nicolet comes out of the box. Now it's a man advantage for the Pack. Nicolet slinging it deep. Hauser will play it. He hands it off to Rouillet. He can't clear it out. Good play by Wiseman to hold it in. He'll drop it back to Lundmark. He winds, doesn't shoot. Lundmark to Jernander, back to Lundmark. Ooh, it nearly got outside the line, but Lundmark recovered. Jernander can't find Hamilton. Wiseman sends it to Nicolet. Wolfpack working it around the perimeter here. Rouillet takes it away. Can't clear it past Hamilton. Now Chad Wiseman spins it back toward Hamilton. Rouillet blocks that. But it'll be kept in by Nicolet. To Hamilton. Looking to turn toward the front. Hamilton shoots off the side of the goal. Rebound to Jernander. He slips a check. Jernander dropping it back toward the point. It's off of Nicolet's stick. And Lundmark will have to pick it back up in center ice. Lundmark looking for a seam into the offensive zone. He can't get it deep, and it's cleared away and down the rink. And the Wolfpack will have to head back. Nicolet with time for one more rush, heading up ice. And a long pass is deflected before it gets to Bale, but up comes Hamilton, right in, shoot, pad, saved by Hauser. And Wiseman just missed on the rebound. All the penalties are over, and a 2-on-1 break developing here for Manchester. Schmidt holding, tries to center, but it rolls off his stick. And LaBarbera able to squeeze it. We'll be right back.
Adam Hauser, the goaltender, having to deal with Jeff Hamilton as he breaks down the wing. Watch his little snap wrist shot along the ice. Stick side almost catches him at the other end. Kostopoulos gets down 2-on-1, and the puck bounces over his stick. LaBarbera coming up with an easy save.
5-on-5 play here. We haven't seen a lot of that in this game. Murray loses his stick as he back checks on Kankel. Now Ryan pushes it loose. He's held up by Murray. It's over Grabeshkov's head. Peros has a dump in block, and Murray carries the puck. Murray leaving it for Taylor with a wrist shot. That's blocked. And Peros will start a 3-on-2 the other way. He elects to dump it in, and LaBarbera calmly gloves that. Lifted. Can't get it out. Kanko knocked it down. Peros trying to play it toward the front. Taylor intercepts that. But he can't get enough on a clearing attempt. Kanko knocked down. There's going to be another penalty. I jinxed it by saying we were 5-on-5. And now Trevor Gillies wants a piece of one of the Monarchs. That's going to bring a big scrum down. Gillies wrestling around as is lifted with one of the Monarchs. And Peros tackled, lifted. That brought another Wolfpack in. Gillies was on top of Peter Kanko. Now you see Murray exchanging pleasantries with Steckel. And Gillies and Kanko are led away from the proceedings. Lifton re-securing his jersey. And the ice is littered with sticks and gloves. I think both teams are a little frustrated by the number of penalties that have been handed out in this game. The Monarchs got the short end in the first period, and the Wolfpack has spent most of the second period penalty killing.
Well, they have done that, and this they're going to pick another one up here as Jake Taylor tries to clear the puck and fans on it and ends up pulling a guy down right here. He fans on it. Down goes Kinko. And now Gillies comes in, wants to stir it up with Peros right there. That's a mug. And that's going to right now, Kinko comes in, grabs him. Peros gets up. And you're going to see it's a 2-on-1, and all of a sudden Peros is going to get back into it. Now comes Jake Taylor, and everybody's got somebody. They got a piece, they got an arm, they got a leg. Now this is interesting. Garth Murray ends up here with David Stenkel. Now, this is interesting because, number one, if you're a scout and watch when they lock up, Stenkel will not look at Garth Murray. And because he won't look at him, you see right there, he's looking away. That means he doesn't want to do it. And that's a scout's opinion right there.
David Stenkel, a first-round pick by the LA Kings. We're going to show you some big hits here.
Now, it is a physical game. Everybody's banging around. You don't miss your man. These two teams know this is the first place hockey club playing the second place hockey club, and they're out to make a point. Oh, it's a thing of beauty, isn't it?
That's great with the natural sound, too. You can really hear how those hits rattle the boards.
This is the goal that was the start of the goal that the Wolfpack had gotten, but now are trailing by one here in the second period.
It's SRO in the penalty boxes right now, especially on the Wolfpack side. Look at all those guys. And Craig Weller says, man, we need some fresh water in here.
Ryan McGill said, guys, I want a team meeting on this side of the ice.
That's Lifton that he's talking to. I found it interesting too, Brad, that during that last 5-on-3 kill, the one that was successful, the two rookies, Lifton and Taylor, were out on the ice together. Wolfpack individual game tickets are on sale. Catch Jed Ortmeier, Dominic Moore, Joseph Bale, and AHL MVP goaltender Jason LaBarber in action. Tickets start as low as $16 to purchase. Visit HartfordWolfpack.com or call Ticketmaster at 212-307-7171. But Ryan McGill really shows a lot of confidence in his young players.
Well, it's true, but you have to remember, you know, when there's 5-on-3, Weller was in the box. He usually plays with McMillan. Nicklick was in the box. He plays with Lampen. That was the only pair that are used to playing with each other. But they, granted, they are both rookies, and Nick Fetillo and Ryan McGill showing some confidence in them. And it's very hard. I mean, when you're playing, when you're killing a 5-on-3. You know, as a defenseman, you got to remember they can have all the perimeter shots they can get. They just can't have the back door, the goal mouth pass, and you've got to be back there to get to the rebound. And when you're killing a 5-on-3, you know, you start running out trying to block shots. You start running out and opening up your triangle, and you're just going to expose yourself all that much more. So technically, you've really got to think it very simple. You can't take a penalty. You can't because that's going to make that 5-on-3 go longer. You can give them all the perimeter shots that they want because, you know, that's what they're either going to give them, but you're just not going to give them any goal mouth or backdoor passes.
We talked to Ryan McGill earlier asking him about his coaching style. Here's what he had to say on that.
I think I show a lot of compassion to the game and a lot of compassion to the player, and I really believe that if you work with these players on and try to work with them on an individual level and work on their deficiencies and work on them positively day in, day out. I really care about the well-being of the player and getting them to the next level. And I'm a very intense person, but I think along with the intensity goes a little bit of logic too.
And that really shines through when you see how he has the back and forth with these guys. He really has a good feel of knowing when they need a kick in the rear end and when they need a pat on the back, so to speak.
Well, the coach is the guy that's in charge, and you know, he showed, I think, very positive thing. He did sit down, Lundmark and Ballet, two of his top performers, and got a response from the team that he wanted, and now he's putting them back on the ice, giving them lots of ice time.
Brown's shot is blocked wide. As you see, it's still 5-on-5 out there. After all that rough stuff, there's no power play for either side, and LaBarber covers it up. And it really, truly, that's a break for the Wolfpack, Brad, is before that all broke out, the Pack were going to get a penalty.
I thought they were going to get two. Number one, I thought Taylor taking down Kenko after he coughed the puck up was one penalty. Gillies coming over and mugging George Parros would have been another one. But the referee says, well, maybe if we get 5-on-5, maybe we can get this game to move along a little bit.
One negative for the Wolfpack out of all the penalties that were called is that Taylor got a game misconduct, so they're down a defenseman. Camilleri throws it across toward Brown. It's off his skate. Brown keeps it alive. Now they stuff it toward the front. LaBarber forced to make a save on a close-in try by Camilleri, looking for his second of the game, and LaBarber hangs on.
Mike Camilleri smelling out a good opportunity. Here's the puck behind the net, and it's going to end up in front. Here comes Camilleri right there as the puck was one-handed out by Jeff Giuliano. LaBarber doing a terrific job, as I said. You try to wrap around on him. He gets, with those long legs, he gets side to side very quickly, and he'll shut everything down along the ice with that paddle.
Taylor apparently being tossed out for being the third man into an altercation when he came in late. You saw it on one of those replays that we showed as the Wolfpack get hit with an icing call here.
I think that might be a little unfair. There's two or three guys that could have got third man in, right? Everybody wanted a piece of somebody.
And once Gillies came in there, it was kind of a free-for-all. And we'll get a draw here between Moore and LaHoo. The Wolfpack win it. Hamilton with a lead pass to Moore. Moore coughs it up. Kostopoulos looking to turn the other way. He'll elect to dump it in. LaBarbera feeds it off to McMillan. He finds Hamilton with a lead pass on the tape of Giroux. He has the only Wolfpack goal. Giroux, a wide angle shot easily handled by Hauser, and he'll hang on. And now Rouillet throws Giroux into the goal net. That's going to bring another town meeting down in the Manchester Monarch crease.
Boy, I tell you, it must be snowing out because I'm seeing a lot of face washes out there.
The scary thing is this is just the second game of eight all year between these two teams.
Yeah, hey, listen, let's get it on. And Giroux coming down just throws one at the net. But what started is this, he continues on looking for a rebound, even though there's no rebound. And as he comes right now, watch Rouillet right there, take him into the net and say, where are you going? And Hamilton comes in, a little shot from behind. That's why those guys wear those visors, you know, just for the face wash.
At least you don't get it in your eyes that way.
Well, I tell you, imagine how much Windex they go through on that bench.
Between the sweat and the marks from the gloved hands, it's got to be pretty tough to keep those things clean.
Now, one thing about all these penalties is they really throw off your rhythm as a team, the flow and on how, you know, that really happens out of the game. And once you get into a flow, everything works well for you, and this disrupts it with a lot of these penalties.
Weller knocks Weaver down. Now Wiseman has it. Got a power play here for the Wolfpack as Rouillet got sent to the box for roughing up Giroux, but out come the Monarchs shorthanded. Camilleri gets bumped by Weller. LaBarbera out with Giuliano coming from the backside. Now Lundmark will take over. Monarchs scored twice on 5-on-3s within a span of 26 seconds earlier in this second period. Wolfpack trying to get organized on this power play. Nicolet has it poked away, but up jumps Wiseman right in. Wiseman shoots, and Hauser makes the save. He'll hang on. Wiseman used Weaver as a screen there, and here we go again. Punches, exchange, wrestling going on. Doesn't seem like we can get through one whistle without having a big scrum.
Now Wiseman went in, snapped one along the ice, and good left pad save by Adam Hauser. And I don't know what started this one, but nobody's looking right there. Weller goes in and chops it. Oh, I see what started now. Not only did he chop it, but when the Manchester player came in, Weller throws a little right-hand cross. Watch this, right there, boom, and he's already still throwing the punch before the guy even lays the cross check on him.
Weller's going to the penalty box here. Wiseman, one of the Wolfpack's assistant captains, is over to petition the referee O'Rourke, who has been a busy man in this one to this point.
There's a look at Chad Wiseman. Quick wrister under the defenseman going down, got it to the net. Weller going to look for the rebound. Throws a little right cross. Oh, we get a double minor. Two for slashing, two for roughing.
So that's not only going to cancel out the rest of the Wolfpack power play, but it's going to give the Monarchs 2 minutes and 40 seconds of power play time once Rouillet gets out of the box.
I don't know, even if Rouillet gets out the way this is going, there'll be somebody else in there.
Currently 4-on-4, and the Wolfpack get the draw. Nicolet looking for an opening, tries to whip it in front, but it deflects away and outside the zone. Lampman now to Bale. He's hassled by Gleason. Bale fends him off. And it's 3-on-4. Nicolet will set up for the pack. Veteran D-man nearly has it chopped away by Welch. Now Bale bangs with Ryan. Nicolet has it over to Lampman. He's watched by Ryan. Here's Nicolet. With 40 seconds in the 4-on-4. Nicolet looking to get off on a change. Here's Bale with a lane into the offensive zone. Fires one just wide of the far post, held in by Lampman. Vale has it roll past him.
Got any more changes coming here?
Now Weaver gets hit. And the whistle finally blows, and you are right, Brad. We got another penalty here. We'll come back and find out what it is momentarily. 2-1 Manchester here in Hartford.
Well, if you stay with us, again, we have another penalty as Tim Gleason takes a roughing call, and it's going to be 4-on-3 for the Wolfpack. Look at the penalty box. A lot of white jerseys, blue jerseys on that side.
Wolfpack control. A short power play here. Just 16 seconds left on a penalty to Roulier. Lundmark has it. Nicolet can't get to it behind the net. Hamilton has his drop pass intercepted by Schmidt. He'll clear it down the rink, and that'll do it for Roulier's penalty. Now it's going to be a minute 38 up for a side before Weller's penalties kick in again, and Manchester goes back to the power play. Lundmark slides it toward Hamilton. He's got a man open in front, and that was Lampman, but the pass was blocked. Lampman now feeds toward Hamilton. Instead, it's to Nicolet, but his backhander never got through. And back the other way comes Dustin Brown. Brown firing one, but Lampman blocks that wide, and it goes all the way up into the netting for a stoppage in play.
Well, I tell you, you know, we don't have to go into overtime to see 4-on-4 in this game. I'd like to find out exactly how long, how many minutes and seconds we played 5-on-5 in this game, because there has been a slew of penalties.
I think our statistician Alex Case's pen has already run out of ink, so I don't know if we're going to get that. But in any case, it remains 4-on-4 now, and Moore will lean in against LeHou. Lifton and Kostopoulos after that loose puck. Now Kostopoulos is knocked down, but Grabeshkov intercepts a Wolfpack pass. LaBarbera will settle it down for McMillan. Wolfpack lost a defenseman when Taylor was tossed out. They already have the converted forward Weller playing on the blue line with Thomas Polk out with an ankle sprain. Roulier has a feed blocked by Bale. He'll drop it off to Lifton. 48 seconds in the 4-on-4. In comes Lifton up from the defense. Nobody there behind the net. Schmidt will take over. Now it's Kostopoulos snapping it into the Wolfpack zone. 33 seconds on the 4-on-4. Long feed finds McMillan. His dumping is blocked right back to him. Wolfpack in a change. That gives Grabeshkov some time. In 20 seconds, the Monarchs will go back to the power play for about a minute. Grabeshkov going to deal it ahead to Kanko, but Jernander blocks that. Now Grabeshkov is hit hard by Ortmeier. And Lampman knocks the dump in down. Jed Ortmeier able to find Nicolet. Now Jernander feeds back to Nicolet. 2-on-1 down low. Nicolet shoots him. Hauser gets a piece of that. Rebound to Ryan as the Monarchs go to the power play. Kanko kind of step past Lampman. Kanko holds. Shoot. LaBarbera holds the post. Rebound picked up by Lampman. And he's got plenty of room. He'll slap it all the way down. Hauser can't get to it. And it'll be picked up by Camilleri. Tim Gleason is down after contact behind the play. LeHou fumbles it away. Brown now feeds to Camilleri. Return pass eludes Brown, but he picks it up from Kostopoulos. Brown sends it into the slot, but Lifton, a smart defensive play to break that up. Out comes Hauser to meet it. 24 seconds on the power play. Dennis Grabeshka. To Camilleri with a long feed. Here it's dealt ahead by Kostopoulos, but too far for Brown. Now the Monarchs get a forecheck going. Brown looks toward the front. McMillan knocked down Kostopoulos. Here's a drive from in the slot by Grabeshkov. LaBarbera gets a piece of that. The penalty getting set to expire. And a pass is blocked with a lead feed by Lifton, just missing Helminen. Weller out of the penalty box into pressure. He fends off Grabeshkov. Weller trying to protect the puck with his body. Camilleri knocks it away. It goes right toward the front of the goal. They score! A whole host of players there in front. It got backhanded up under the crossbar. And the Wolfpack have tied it up.
Well, it looks like Dwight Helminen throws a high backhander. As they come out of the box, Craig Weller, being much fresher coming out of the box, knocks Dennis Grabeshkov off the puck right here. Grabeshkov had been on for a while. Weller digging it out. The puck's going to come to the front of the net right there. And Ryan Howick goes backhand, top shelf.
Second goal in as many games for Hallweg, and it was kind of an innocent looking movement of the puck going off the side of the net there. Hauser couldn't block it. Next thing he knew, Hallweg was able to fight off Grabeshkov, and what a beautiful high shot over his shoulder.
Grabeshkov losing his stick after getting knocked down by Weller. Has nothing to fend off the stick of Hallweg, and he throws it up top.
This has been a weird second period. Manchester Monarchs capitalized on an extended period of 5-on-3 to get two goals inside a 30-second span. And now the Wolfpack have tied it up just after a long period of penalty killing. Ortmeier in to track the puck. He'll beat Schmidt to it. Those two bang. Now it comes to Murray. He looks for help from Ortmeier, and he gets it. Hauling in behind the net. Hands it off to Murray. Backhander from close range. Turned away by Hauser. Kept alive by Ortmeier. Here's Murray to Hauling. Now Murray, a bad angle shot. Hauling holds the post. Or rather, Hauser, I should say. Kept in nicely by Lifton. Right in front of Hauling, looking for another one. And he put it wide of the goal. Parros bumped by Murray. But the puck comes to Roulier. And he sends Schmidt to center. He'll jam it down into the pack zone. Failed to clear the red line. It's icing. We're now tied at two here in Hartford. We'll be right back.
At the start of the game, we said that Garth Murray likes to stir the pot. Big hit on George Parros. A little cross-check to let him know he's there. Garth Murray stirring the pot. Ryan Hallweg comes up with a big goal right here. Grabeshkov, no stick. And Hallweg stays with it. Goes top shelf over Adam Hauser, 2-2. With 5:15 left here in the second period.
13:38 the time of that goal. Hallweg is fourth of the year from Weller and Murray. Here's Hamilton shooting. That's off the blocker of Hauser. And Moore tried to feed it in front, but Hauser able to block that. And as they finally enjoy some 5-on-5 play, the Wolfpack seem to be coming on a little bit here.
Jeff Hamilton makes himself dangerous because he snaps a wrister through traffic, through legs, under armpits, and gets it on net. Adam Hauser has got to know that Jeff Hamilton is going to get that puck to the net.
Monarchs breaking out here with Welch. Backhanding a pass that goes behind Kanko. Weller controls to Hamilton. His dump in is off of Weaver's glove right to Giroux. Giroux held up by Weaver, a good recovery. Now Ryan will take over. The Welch. He finds Kanko trying to step past Weller, but Weller recovers. And it's out in center with Moore getting held up. That's going to be a penalty call against the Manchester Monarchs as Weller got a glove to the puss. And the Wolfpack are going to go to a power play.
Weller putting a little hit right here. That's finishing the hit. And as he moves the puck up the ice, Dominic Moore trying to take off, gets held by Ryan and thrown down. Very, very obvious penalty. You gotta have the puck. You can't take the man out unless he's got the puck. Now that rule hasn't changed about 50 years. Fortunately, I guess Ryan has not played that long.
Just a rookie.
Matt Ryan, 1983 birthday.
That doesn't seem like all that long ago. Nicolette drops it off to Ballet. Wolfpack trying to reclaim the lead here on a power play. Ballet looking toward the front. And this passes out of the reach of Weller. And back come the Monarchs shorthanded. Kostopoulos dishes it to Roulier. His sharp angle shot misses way wide. And Weaver is forced back to his own blue line. In this 2-2 game. And as Weaver tries to clear it down the rink, he puts it out of play. Not what he wanted to do. And there'll be a face-off in the Manchester zone.
Now Mike Weaver just trying to lay it softly off the glass. The bad news is he cleared it into the stands of the penalty box area, but the face-off's going to be deep in his zone while they're on the penalty kill. It's one thing to get it out, to get it down. You got people deep in your zone. All you have to do is get it outside the blue line. That's going to kill 10 seconds.
Leeson drives it up the wall, and he'll force the Wolfpack back into their own zone. LaBarbera handing it off to Lampman. Goals by Giroux and Hallweg, and this one for the Wolfpack. Camilleri and Clark have scored for the Monarchs as Clark clears it right back down. LaBarbera will leave it off for Lampman. He's on the point with McMillan, Moore, Hamilton and Giroux up front. Now Clark blocks a pass. And Weaver will look to slap it down the rink, but it hit Noah Clark. Lampman turns with it. Now here's McMillan. He'll look to fire it in, and he does. First man to it is Gleason. He's forechecked by Hamilton. The puck to Alex Giroux. He's held up, and it'll be taken away by Brown, who clears it all the way down. And the Monarchs gets up slowly after a confrontation with Giroux. In comes Lundmark. Going to go wide on Weaver. Now he'll feather it over toward Hamilton. Back to Lundmark. He'll hand back to Hamilton. Lundmark again. Has a backhanded feed. He finds Nicolet. He fans on the shot. Does a good job to get in the defender's way, though. The Wolfpack keep it in. Bouncing puck finally cleared away. And down the rink, and LaBarbera will move it to Nicolet. He steps into the offensive zone. Nicolet holding, throws it at the goal. Sticked away by Hauser. Penalty expiring. Wiseman looking for someone to pass to. Now has a feed deflected. It hops over Weller's stick. Kept in nicely by Nicolet. New Wiseman, now Lundmark. Sends behind the net to Bale. Wiseman trying to get free in front. Bale still with it. Has a centering feed blocked by Weaver. Lehou can't clear. Kept in by Weller. Bouncing puck behind the net. Ends up on Bale's stick. Now Bale drops it off toward Weller. It's back to Bale. Again to Weller. Weller on his backhand. Puts it in front. It's knocked away toward the line. Held in by Lifton with a slap shot. That's blocked by Ryan. And it'll be cleared up the wall. Just past Lifton and all the way down. This will be icing against Manchester.
Manchester fighting and holding off their life right there as they had to kill that penalty. And even when it was 5-on-5, they couldn't get it out. Here's Weller driving to the net, trying to get it in front. Nice play by Lehou, checking that. Lifton shooting the puck. Ryan blocking it. And Ryan almost gets hit by his own defenseman as it goes into the corner. His defenseman goes and slaps it off the glass, but just missing him. And almost got it from both sides.
Grabeshkov now for Manchester, held up by Helman, a loose puck. And James nearly put it right in front of his own net, and Hauser smartly decides to put the glove down on top of it and stop play. Monday night on MSG, look into the Rangers' future. Catch Future Blue, an hour-long discussion series profiling the future of the New York Rangers Monday night at 10:30, only on MSG Network. You're seeing some Future Blue right here with guys like Dwight Helmanen and Ryan Hallwick. Helmanen will take the draw against James. James wins it. Helmanen still able to pressure Grabeshkov. Now Janander keeps it into the line. Oh! Flip went through a screen and just wide. Rebound to Peros. And it bounces past McMillan. He'll have to head back. And Lifton and James wrestle around in front of a goal. Now Lifton to center ice. Banks a pass toward Hallwick, but it's too far. Back comes Peros. Only one man back for the Wolfpack. Peros shoots, and that goes high and wide. Rebound kept in by Steckel. Now Giuliano sends it in behind the net where he's met by McMillan. Giuliano spins away, trying to stuff it in front of McMillan, knocks him down hard. The puck controlled by Helmanen. His feet is blocked by Steckel, but Lifton fires it out of there. They're inside the final minute of the second. McMillan has his lead pass go too far for Helmanen, and this will be icing against the Wolfpack.
Now, Bob, both teams not taking any chances here late in the second. They're icing it when they're tired. They're not looking for an option. They just want to get off. I think both teams would be very happy to get out of this period the way it's been. The amount of penalties and power plays, I think that you'll see things settle down in the third period. But right now, they're gasping. They've been working hard with all those penalties and power plays.
Wiseman for the Wolfpack. Has a rolling puck. Now he drops it back to Lampman. Lampman jumping up again. Feeds Wiseman up the gut. Wiseman trying to step through the defense. Puck slides on goal. And Hauser keeps it out of the cage. Bale finds Lundmark. He tries to stick handle toward the front now. Lampman keeps it in. Lampman on his forehand shooting. Hauser knocks that down. Rebound to Rouillet. And it'll get past Lundmark and away to center. Good late pressure there by the Wolfpack. As Nicolet and Lampman play catch. Now Rouillet gloves it down. With a lead toward Camilleri, gets through him. Camilleri able to send it in, but Nicolet is right there, and that's going to do it for the second period. Lots going on in that second frame. It ends up with the two clubs all even.
Bryce Lampman giving the puck in here. Looks to the pass to the corner, but gets to the front of the net. Good shot, good save by Adam Hauser. A heads-up play by Bryce Lamp.
So it's 2-2 after two. The clubs troop off. Should set up a pretty entertaining third period here at the Hartford Civic Center. Wolfpack and the Manchester Monarchs. We'll return with more after a break here with Deuces Wild at the Hartford Civic Center. Two-two tie, the Wolfpack in Manchester headed into the third period. Next Saturday night on MSG, the Wolfpack defend home ice against the Providence Bruins. Live coverage gets underway at 7 p.m. next Saturday night here on MSG Network. The Manchester Monarchs with a pair of power play goals. The Hartford Wolfpack have one on a power play, one at even strength. The Wolfpack with a 26-20 shots on goal advantage looking for their second straight win in the season series against the Monarchs.
Kind of a crazy game so far. I mean, lots of action. We haven't been disappointed that way. We've seen both Terry teams, you know, stand up for territory in front of their own nets. We've seen both teams, take some penalties without really having, making bad decisions, lack of discipline. But when it comes down after two periods, it's 2-2. I think the third period is going to be an entertaining period, with the 2 points will take the priority now.
And the big fella from the North Pole taking time out to enjoy some Wolfpack hockey. Got to be a pretty busy time of the year for him.
Well, you got to take a night off once in a while.
Adam Hauser, perfect on the year at 7-0-0, as Matthew Garrard has been in nets for all three Manchester Monarch losses. And that unblemished record is on the line here this evening for Hauser, who's a third-year pro out of the University of Minnesota. And Jason LaBarbera is in quest of his sixth straight win. He came into tonight leading the league in goals against average and second in save percentage.
Goaltenders are a very huge commodity in the game of hockey, because it's different than pitchers in baseball, where they can really influence the game. But a goaltender can be the same goaltender night after night after night, and if he's on a hot streak, it really gives a good opportunity for his team to win.
Faceoff won by the Wolfpack as Helminen gets it back to Lampman. Helminen out there with Hallwig and Jernander. Kanko trying to tip it ahead for the Monarchs. Now it's Cerulier. Ryan fended off by Lampman, and Helminen takes it. Helminen started the year with Charlotte. He's been a solid contributor to the Wolfpack since his call-up. Wolfpack hemmed in their own zone. Nicolet has a man right on him, but he's able to clear it. Taken back in center by Kanko. Fernando pressuring Doug Nolan. Now Lampman will move back. To a turning Helminen. Now it's Nicolet. Nicolet held up by Welch. Now it deflects to Hallwig, and he'll get the Wolfpack a line change. Doug Nolan, former BC Eagle, dropping to Roulier. With a lead off of Camilleri's stick, chasing it is Giuliano. He's bumped by Weller. Weller trying to one-hand it out. The dangerous Camilleri lurking there as well. Lundmark with a good back check on Camilleri. Gleason keeps it in momentarily. Now McMillan looks to clear again. Gleason knocks it down, but it was with his hand, and that results in a hand pass call as it comes to Camilleri. Now Wiseman and Gleason stare at one another, but they're quickly separated.
Now Tim Gleason kind of limped off the ice there in the second period, but showing no worse for wear as he locks a little horns with Chad Wiseman.
Gleason, a former Ottawa Senators first rounder, was swapped in March of 2003 to Los Angeles for Brian Smolinski. And now those hardworking guys in the stripes are going to do some housekeeping.
Now looking probably a little divot down by that goal post, and that's one thing that could affect LaBarbera as he slides to the left post. If he hits that skate on a rut, he might not get all the way to the post. He may lose his balance when he gets there.
Lundmark and Camilleri on the draw here. And it's won by Lundmark. Jeff McMillan looking for an opening. Slides it ahead to Lundmark. His dump in deflects to Wiseman, but it's cleared right back out. Now a long pass finds Camilleri. McMillan trying to cut off the angle on him. Camilleri eludes McMillan behind the net, but the loose puck is to Lundmark. And he'll get it out of trouble for the Wolfpack. Right back is Jeff Giuliano. He's held up. Giuliano drops it to Gleason, now to Weaver. He guns it in. Monarchs into a shift change. They keep it in the offensive zone. Bale fends off Camilleri. Bale is going to take an icing here. Whistle will blow, and that'll give the Wolfpack an opportunity to change line.
It's interesting looking at Mike Camilleri, not a big guy, 5'9 at the most. Twice on that last shift, he was outsized, out-muscled by McMillan, and he pulled the ripcord, and then just over on that far side, he did the same thing. He's a smart player that knows that, you know, when a guy's got you cold turkey, you just don't keep going and take that punishment.
Now, once again, they're having problems with that crease that LaBarbera is defending. Marty Demers trying to smooth it out.
That's a very bad spot. You see, it's right next to that post. That's exactly where LaBarbera's skate comes over and starts to dig in. Now, you know, they're trying to pack it with ice and put water and rely on the refrigeration system below the ice in order to do that. One of the things that they've done in the past is they'll bring out a fire extinguisher that CO2 with the cold air and freeze it immediately, but we'll have to keep an eye on that because that could be very detrimental to LaBarbera's performance.
Speaking of goal creases, the Wolfpack with LaBarbera and Steve Valiquette here, two great goaltenders and two unbelievable prospects too in the Ranger organization, Brad.
Well, you got to look at Al Montoya, number one pick for the Rangers last year, sixth overall. He's recorded his 12th shutout at the University of Michigan. A career, he's three shy of the all-time leader, Marty Turco, and Henrik Lundqvist is 22 years old in the 2000s. He leads the Swedish Elite League.
Which is a pretty good league.
Especially now with a lot of players from the National Hockey League still playing in that league. So, I mean, that's a very 9.933 save percentage, 1.83 goals against. And that's usually a little wide open, big ice surface rink over there. So Lundqvist doing it. Terrific job.
Now we'll take a look at some great forward prospects here. A Finnish kid, Korpakoski, a Canadian major junior, and Callahan is an American-born player playing in the Ontario Hockey League.
Well, Lord Korpakoski is a young center. He was first pick in 2004. And all these players have been named for the juniors this year. Korpakoski for Finland, Nigel Dawes for Team Canada, and Ryan Callahan, who's 19 for Team USA, and that's going to be in the 05 juniors, and should be very, very entertaining as these guys go against each other. Nigel Dawes has played a couple of playoff games up here, or late season games last year with the Wolfpack.
We're going to take a break here with the work still to be done on the ice, 2-2 early in the third period here in Hartford. Garth Murray, a young prospect for the New York Rangers organization, a big, tough player. We asked Nick Fatiu for his impressions of Garth Murray.
Garth is like a Nick Fatiu. He likes to bang and hustles, and he has a lot of enthusiasm, and he hustles around the rink and likes to hit everything that moves, so it's New York fans will love him too.
You can see the joy that Nick has when he talks about a young guy like Garth who's just on the way up and really plays a style that Nick Fatiu respects.
Sure. It looked like a father talking about his son, didn't it?
It sure did.
You can see the ice crew working with a fire extinguisher trying to freeze that slush that they put in there in order to get this period started. I think they'll keep that on hand right by the Zamboni doors in case that little wedge of ice comes out again.
Again, the building getting a real workout today with a concert earlier. And part of the ice was covered. I don't believe it was that part, but a lot of people, a lot of open doors, and kind of a humid day in Hartford as well. Not good for ice conditions. It'll be a face-off between Moore and LeHoux. We're out there with Hamilton and Giroux on a dangerous Wolfpack line. And the pack control the puck. Giroux with a long breakaway pass. That went off of Schmidt. And Hamilton was nearly able to gather it in for what would have been a one-on-one chance on Hauser. Giroux drops it back to Lampman. He deals it toward Moore. Gets through him. And that's going to be an icing violation against the Wolfpack.
I'm surprised. I think that hit a stick in the neutral zone.
I thought I heard something too.
Yeah, I think it's really nice. It might be an offside pass, but it looks like they're going to bring it all the way down because it hit a stick or a leg on the side and bounced over the blue line. A good break for the actually for Manchester as it comes to the faceoff comes to the left of Arbor.
Murray is beaten on the draw. Here's a drive by Roulier. That's blocked. Rebound. Controlled by Ortmeier as Steckel is knocked down by Murray. Now Ortmeier steps to center. Long pass too far for Murray. Now Gillies and Peros are going to drop the gloves. And they lock up. Peros, a great big guy. And Gillies wrestles into the ice. He threw a left hand there. I don't know if it connected. And as you saw a second ago, Peros is already cut above one of his eyes. That's from falling into the boards earlier in the game. And the Peros, who is 6'5" and 215 pounds, heads on to the penalty box.
Trevor Gillies is going to get in a wrestling match as probably size this position on Peros. Tall, lanky guy at 6'5". Well, when you look at Trevor Gillies, not nearly that tall, but he's 225, 6'3", so a little closer to the ice. Has some good shift, but this is two heavyweights duking it out. Peros gets that first one in there. That was a dandy. But Gillies comes back and just overpowers him.
Gillies leading the Hartford Wolfpack in penalty minutes coming into this game with 97. No power play off of that. And the puck off of Roulier's glove. No problem for the Monarchs as Nolan plays it. David Steckel is double teamed by Murray and Ortmeier, and there's going to be a penalty called here against the Wolfpack.
I think this is going to go against Garth Murray because as Ortmeier was going in for the hit on Grabeshkov, you have to look what was happening, and Murray was coming from the blind side, and he's going to get a boarding call. And this is what I mean right there. That's Steckel who takes it. He sees Ortmeier but doesn't see Murray, and that's going to be a boarding because no doubt about that. Not a good penalty to take. As I said, the 2 points are the most important thing here. You know, putting a team on the power play in the third period, not a good decision.
This will be the eighth power play for Manchester. They've scored twice on power plays. The Wolfpack have had 9 man advantages.
Well, Manchester leads the league in power play with 21.4%.
You saw a shot on the bench. Steckel ended up with a little bit of a bloody nose on that one, but it's not going to bother him too much. Weller, a good defensive play at the blue line, and a late run taken by Kostopoulos at Gernandu. Ortmeier forechecking on the penalty kill, but away comes LeHoux. He drives it into the Wolfpack zone. It'll be kicked loose by Weller. Now Lampman turns in behind the net. Does a good job to avoid LeHoux, but he can't clear it past Brown. Brown sends it into the corner to Tom Kostopoulos. LeHoux behind the net. Centers one, and LaBarbera able to track it down despite having Brown right in his face, and LaBarbera will cover it up.
Yank LeHoux just throwing a soft backhander out in front with Dustin Brown going to the net, but Brown wasn't really ready for it. Actually, it's Kostopoulos going to the net right there, and there was no way he was going to get position in order to get a shot off. Pass a little bit too soon with nobody wide open. One thing you got to remember when you're behind that net, you're off to the side, the first thing the opposing team covers is the front of the net. So if the pass isn't there, you got to start looking deep.
McMillan off the draw, able to feed it to Wiseman. He flips it up in the air, can't get it out. Grabeshkov holds it in. Grabeshkov winding, shooting. That goes high and wide. Rebound shot past Camilleri by Moore. Good hustle by Grabeshkov to get there, but his pass is intercepted by McMillan, and he'll clear it all the way down. Stopped off by Hauser for Kostopoulos. He's got Moore all over him. Now Camilleri turns with it. 50 seconds on the power play. Kostopoulos feeds it to Tim Gleason. He'll wrist it in. LaBarbera can't stop it. Nicolet pokes it up in the air. A good play, but it deflects up and out of play. That went straight out, I believe, off of Nicolet. So the faceoff will be inside the Wolfpack zone.
Actually, I think when Nicolet tried to flip it over the head of the Manchester player, it hit his hand and went over the boards, and they brought the faceoff outside.
Right you are, Brian. Didn't think it hit anything on the way out, but clearly it did, and the Wolfpack get the draw. Gleason will stop it off and look to set things up for Manchester on the power play. Ryan puts on the brakes. Now he's a feet blocked as McMillan stepped up. Ryan will dish it off to Gleason. Gleason watched by Ortmeier. Here's a long pass to Ryan, held up by Jernander. And Nicolet pokes it right back out of it. Clark off the pass from Gleason, fires in. LaBarbera sets it up for Nicolet, and he'll pound it past Clark, and that'll just about do it for the Manchester power play. Gleason on the puck. Hands it ahead to Schmidt. He rolls it in on goal. LaBarbera feeds it to Lifton. He can't slide it past Ryan. Now Weller intercepts a centering pass. He rips it toward the line, and Murray will step to center to Lundmark. Lundmark holding and shooting. Pat saved by Hauser. Rebound to Kanko. He can't get it out. Bale, though, has it stripped away by Clark. And away comes Kanko. He can't shove it across the pack line. Lundmark held up from behind, still able to dump it in. 2-2 your score here in Hartford, Connecticut. Kanko drives it past Weller. It'll go all the way down. And this will be icing against the Manchester Monarchs.
Neither team shy on icing the puck if they think they're a little tired, as Kanko did it at that time. But the Wolfpack not letting the Manchester Monarchs get out of their end very easily. A lot of good, strong forechecking, good backchecking. That's a look right there. Jamie Lundmark releasing that quick wrister on the right pad of Hauser. Ken Jernander forcing Matt Ryan along the boards, making sure he can't get in the zone.
Here's a long drive by Hamilton. That's blocked right back to him. He'll try it again. This time it's tipped wide of the cage. And James jumps on it for the Monarchs. Welch can't handle his pass. Lampman flips it up in the air. Now Nicolet will find himself in control. He tips it down to the side of the goal. Hauser sets the table for Nolan to Roulier. He hands a breakout pass to Steckel. Now it's James. 3-on-2. Steckel has James's feed goal behind him, but it was offside anyway.
Great back checking by the Wolfpack as they're not giving the Manchester Monarchs any room to skate with that puck. As soon as the guy starts to take a stride, there's a Wolfpack player right on him, and that forced that offside right there as Connor James was trying to move the puck, ended up putting it behind his guy because he had pressure.
Lundmark beaten on the draw by Camilleri. Hard around, comes to the near side. Lampman trying to whack it out of there. Can't get it by Giuliano. Now it's stolen by Lundmark. He's got Bale with him. Bale picks up the pass off the board. Bad angle, shot right on him. Hauser makes the save. Rebound blocked wide by Weaver. And Bale ends up on top of the puck. Wiseman grabs it free. Lundmark shoved by Weaver. And Weaver will play it away to Giuliano. Brown breaking 2-on-1 with Camilleri. Brown holding. Brown still with it. Has it hop over his stick and in behind the net. Now he bangs with Wiseman. Lundmark helping out. And he does a good job to hook it away from Giuliano. And out come the Wolfpack. Lundmark with some nice stick handling. Now he'll get tripped up by Grabeshkov. That's going to be a penalty against the Monarchs. Hallweg goes into forecheck on Schmidt. As the whistle blows, Hallweg and Schmidt push and shove. Lundmark a little slow to get up. And Grabeshkov is going to go to the sin bin here.
Credit Jamie Lundmark with doing a little dancing through the neutral zone as he beats one guy right here. And he starts to move outside on Grabeshkov, but then cuts back inside. Grabeshkov overshoots him, sticks out that left leg, and Hallweg finishing that check. Here's the one low dig on Camilleri. This is where the penalty is. That left leg of Grabeshkov catches Jamie Lundmark.
Lundmark had some knee problems in his previous tenure with the Ranger organization. You always worry when you see that knee-on-knee contact.
Well, you do. I mean, that was one thing where Grabeshkov was actually sticking his leg out. He didn't have any weight behind it. Not as dangerous when Lundmark got hit last year. There was a lot of, the guy that hit him had a lot of weight on his leg, so it was like hitting a log.
That was Michael Pekka that took out that time. Right point is Jernander to Lampman. Now Hamilton having trouble with it, but it's kept alive by Giroux. Giroux shoots, and Hauser makes the save. Oh, they score, but the whistle will blow. Giroux knifed it out from underneath Hauser's glove, but I think you heard the same thing I did, Brad. The whistle had clearly blown before that puck came loose.
Sure, Adam Hauser had his glove hand on the puck. Alexander Giroux had not heard the whistle, continued to dig at it. The whistle went, and then the puck just slid across the line. Alexander Giroux driving to the net right here. Nice little move, gets a rebound. There's the whistle.
Wolfpack win the ensuing draw. And Giroux will try it again, dishing this time to Moore. Moore looking toward the front, Giroux. As the pack working around, Giroux dangling. Out of Moore, he whips it across toward Hamilton, but it gets through him, held in by Lambert. On this pack power play, Hamilton firing, and that's wide left. Rebound kept in by Jernander. He's bumped, loose puck. Schmidt turns deeper in his own zone. And one of the Monarchs has broken his stick. Here's a centering pass. Moore turning into the corner. Now Moore dropping back to Lampman. To Hamilton. Hamilton to Moore with a bad angle try. That's blocked and Lampman stops a clearing effort. Here's Kenny Jernander to Moore. He feeds it across the side of the deflect just away from Giroux. Kept in again by Jernander. Now Giroux has control to Moore. Moore forced in behind the cage by Schmidt. It's Gleason that's without a stick, one of the D-men. Now Hamilton toward the front, shooting, that's blocked, rebound loose. And Gleason goes down and gloves it past Lampman, a big play there. Back goes Jernander. He'll head off on a shift change, and Nikola turns in behind the net. 23 seconds on the power play. Score tied at 2, Nikola still going. Puts on a fake, now he throws it in front, kicked away by Weaver. Weaver pressured by Nikola. Now Wiseman keeps it in, covering the point, but Kostopoulos works it past him. Now Lundmark has pressure from Clark. Here's a quick lead by Weller that deflects to Wiseman. Penalty is over. Bale hounds it over to Wiseman. He drops it to Nikola. Long shot. Hauser the save. Bale's rebound. Try goes wide. Now Lundmark held up by Clark. Wiseman helps out. Wiseman turning toward the slot. Shoots. And Hauser gets that in the glove. And he will squeeze it for a whistle. Now we get Wiseman and Clark staring at one another.
Pretty sustained action by the Wolfpack as they put a lot of pressure on the goaltender, Hauser. Look at Chad Wiseman right there. One of the Monarchs, Gleason, lost his stick. They actually had three defensemen on because there's Schmidt and Roulier. And that ended up creating a problem for him. There's a long shot that bounces off the pads of Hauser, but no Wolfpack player available. But lots of heat and pressure in the Monarch end.
Scoreless third session to this point. And they're back to full strength. Shots are 31-20 in favor of the Wolfpack in this game. Ortmeier will line up in the slot. Murray taking the draw. Murray has spent most of his pro career on the wing as you look at Mike Camilleri. But with Blair Betts back out of the Wolfpack lineup, Murray has been moved to the middle. We'll go against Camilleri here. And there's the drop. Whistle blows as they rule it was dropped unfairly. And looks like Murray will be ushered out of there as he and Camilleri stare at one another.
Now they back up with Ryan Hallwood, who's a normal centerman, came up as a centerman. He's been on the left wing with Murray at center. So Hallwood's a good replacement going in for the faceoff.
He'll go against Camilleri here. Hallwood's goal tied the game at 13:38 of the second period. And he wins the faceoff here, but Murray's pass is deflected away by Brown, and it goes all the way down. LaBarbera hands it off to Lifton. Now to Ortmeier with a nice lead to Hallwick. He rushes with Murray. Hallwick forced around behind the net, has the puck chopped off his stick. Now he's dragged down. McMillan down with the point, keeps it alive for Murray. He tangles with Grabeshkov. Now it comes Ortmeier to pick it up. Ortmeier feeds Hallwick behind the net. Hallwick centers one. Murray on his backhand. Can't get the trigger pulled. It's kept in by Lifton. And Murray can't settle it down in front, and back come the Monarchs. Carrying it is Giuliano. He's bumped hard by McMillan. Lifton looks to clear it high off the glass. And he does. Grabbing it back is Nolan. He nearly coughed it up to Ortmeier. Now the Monarchs dump in as they head toward the halfway point of this third period. Ortmeier pops it past the point man, Nolan. And Helminen will pressure. Helminen held up by Weaver. Weaver goes down. Now Ryan ties up Helminen. Giroux and Nolan in there as well. Now Jernander takes it. He's got Weaver hounding him. Kenny Jernander drops it back toward the point. Nobody was home for the Wolfpack. Lantman steps up to hit Welch. And a pass is intercepted by Hellman, and he can't dump back in. Hellman gets another try at it, feeding for Jernander. He holds up Nolan. Now it deflects to Hellman and moving toward the front. Hellman can't get loose as Weaver dove down to knock it away. And Welch clears it for Manchester. Nicolette for the Wolfpack with a lead to Dwight Hellman. He gets double teamed by Welch and Roulier. Right back is Schmidt with some room to maneuver. He coughs up the puck, but he's able to keep it for Roulier. There's going to be a penalty to the Wolfpack. Roulier held up as he moves across the line and the whistle blows. We'll come back with a Manchester power play in a moment. It's tied at two.
Well, Dwight Hellman gets stood up with the blue line by Welch and Roulier. He later takes a hooking call right here, and that's going to put a penalty. And no doubt about that. And another power play for the Manchester Monarchs.
It's the 19th man advantage of this game, the ninth for Manchester. They've scored twice on the power play, both on 5-on-3s in the second period. Kostopoulos with a long flip wide of the goal. Ortmeier can't get it to Weller. Brown feeds to Kostopoulos, out to Camilleri. Now it's Grabeshkov to Lehou. Around to Kostopoulos, back to Yannick Lehou. He plays it toward Camilleri on the back door, but he couldn't control it cleanly, and it's cleared away by Jernander.
Now that was a risky pass. Lehou going all the way across for a one-timer to Camilleri. Low percentage.
Camilleri scored a goal on Sunday at Manchester against the Wolfpack on a similar play. Now the Monarchs battling hard to hold it in. Lehou finds Dustin Brown. Here's Lehou. He has a pass broken up, but it comes right to Camilleri. Back to Lehou. He winds, doesn't shoot. Kostopoulos dropping back out toward the line. Now to Lehou. He whips it toward the front, and it deflects just wide. And the pack can't quite get it out. Grabeshkov to Camilleri. Now it's Lehou moving in behind the net. Lehou sends it toward the front. It's knocked aside. Wiseman has it, and he'll clear it just out to center.
Well, Yannick Lehou's had trouble all night. He has not gotten one pass through at a crucial time.
And we're getting a penalty here as Moore got high stick. A shot is stopped by Hauser. And with 33 seconds left on Helmanen's penalty, there's going to be one called against the Monarchs.
Oh, Dennis Grabeshkov, the young defenseman, getting his stick up on Dominic Moore, is going to negate the last 33 seconds of their power play along the boards right here. He goes just trying to reach for the puck. Unintentional, but still, under the rules, he's going to get called.
Just careless use of the stick there.
Well, I don't even think he was, you know, I think it was a combination of Dominic Moore, leaning forward and Grabeshkov having a stick about waist high. But a benefit for the Wolfpack is that's going to negate the last 33 seconds of Hellman's penalty.
They're on a 4-on-4 currently. When Hellman gets out, it'll be power play number 11 in the game for the Wolfpack. Nolan has plenty of time, and he feeds to Welch. Dan Welch to center ice, to Ryan. McMillan moves over to cut off his space. Welch fans on a centering try. Hallwig drops it off to McMillan. Return passes too far on a long drive by Roulier. Hits Welch and goes wide. Now Hallwig with a long lead pass behind Hamilton. Right back is Gleason as the pack go to the power play. Gleason loses it. Still able to slide it toward the goal. And LaBarbera just saw that at the last second. Minute 19 on the penalty to Grabeshkov. As the Wolfpack look to untie the score, Wiseman. Now gets a return pass from Lundmark. Wiseman has it knocked away at the last second as he looked to turn in front. Gleason's held up and he can't get it out. Lundmark fans on a shot. Now he keeps it in for Wiseman. Wrapped up by Weaver. Down comes Nicolette now. Plays it to Wiseman. Back to Nicolette. He has it tipped past him and it's out to center ice. Lundmark recovers for the Wolfpack. And he'll circle with it. Jamie Lundmark, former Rangers first rounder to Nicolette. Lead pass goes under Weller's stick, and it's fired all the way down. LaBarbera stopping it for Nicolette. 30 seconds on the power play. Giroux in the neutral zone has it bumped away by Kostopoulos. Nicolette hustles back, and he's able to work it away from Kostopoulos. Nicolette circles the cage. Time for one more rush on the power play. Nicolette wheeling through center, hands it to Moore. Now it's Giroux. He stuffs it in deep to Moore. Working it toward Nicolette down for the defense. Hamilton feeding for Moore. He centers one. Deflects over to the corner, held in by Hamilton to Moore. Penalty expiring. And Hamilton's dragged down, but he recovers to hold it in. Jamming with Schmidt. Now Nicolette finds Moore. Moore to Hamilton. Guns it drive, and that's blocked by Roulier. Kept in by Moore. They're back to full strength. Pass out of Giroux's reach behind the net. And Kostopoulos plays it away to center ice for the Monarchs. Right back is Lampman to Moore. Trying to get by Schmidt. Moore held up, able to one-hand the puck on goal, but Hauser makes the save. And it's cleared past Lifton and down to the Wolfpack zone. Lampman moving back. And he finds Ortmeier with a long pass to Bale. He loses it at the red line. It's off of Weaver sticking down to the Manchester zone. They're inside the final 5 minutes of regulation. Still tied at two. McMillan with a lead pass off of Ortmeier's stick. And Murray being held up by Giuliano. Murray will pressure Weaver. Nolan behind the net. Has a feed deflected by Bale. Ortmeier feeds it in front, and it's tipped away from Weller. And McMillan will have to hustle back. LaBarbera comes out now to clear it away from Brown. And Ortmeier tracks it in center ice, but he's beaten to it by Gleason. Bale intercepts a pass. Bale being held up from behind. Able to find Murray. Now it's Weller. He lifts it in behind the goal. Grabeshkov beats Bale to it. Grabeshkov can't get it out. Murray jamming with Gleason. Bale takes it now. He's got Grabeshkov on him. Bale dancing around. Now he has a pass blocked. And it'll be cleared away and off to center. Taken back by Weller. Pack heading for a line change. Hauser directs it into the corner to Grabeshkov. He doesn't get much on a clearing try, but Helminen overskates it. And the Wolfpack are forced out of the offensive zone. They dump it right back in. Gleason hit hard by Hallwick. And Jernander will keep it in. Whistle has blown. And we'll take a break as we remain tied at two. Back in a moment.
Young athletes are determined, and Ryan Howard wants a big hit. Almost gets it on Tim Gleason. Another look at him. What do you mean I was out of control? Bang! Oh, boy, that guy wanted a piece of him.
Lewis puck in the Manchester zone. Jernander keeps it alive. Hallwick now trying to fend off Grabeshkov. Jernander shooting, he scores! Kenny Jernander puts the Wolfpack up with 3:42 to go!
The veteran Ken Jernander finds a hole with a wrister from the far face-off circle right here. Helmut gets the draw, he sneaks in, and all of a sudden it's going to go to Jernander, goes into the corner. It's going to move up. Here's Jernander, and it finds a hole, beats Adam Hauser. Looks like it's short side, giving the Wolfpack a 3-2 lead. A wrister by Ken Jernander finds a home for the Wolfpack.
Second of the season for Jernander. His other was an empty netter. Hallwick and Helminen on the assist as the whole line chips in, and they stay out there. Kostopoulos for Manchester. Tula, who his lead pass too far for Clark, and goes all the way down. And it'll be icing against the Monarchs as Lampman and Clark push and shove. Kostopoulos comes in there along with Hallwig. Hallwig with a goal and an assist in this game. We're going to get another look.
Here's a faceoff. It's going to end up back in the corner right here. Kenny Jernander moving in from the point, dumps it deep. And you're going to see Ryan Hallwig right there driving for the puck. Here's the shot, a screenshot right there. As Chris Schmidt, the defenseman, crosses in front of Hauser, and Ken Jernander takes the lead for the Wolfpack.
Back in the offensive zone, but a shot gets blocked, and Brown will move out in a hurry, trying to lay it ahead to Camilleri. Wiseman chasing him. There's going to be a penalty, and a Monarch is upended and falls into the goal net. So the Monarchs are going to go to a power play here, down a goal with 3:09 to play. It's going to be a hooking penalty.
Dustin Brown driving to the net. Gets a little, this actually was not the play with Craig Weller, but it looks like Chad Wiseman gonna get the call. Watching the far side, He reaches out, grabs with both hands, and that's Mike Camilleri, and that's the call. Going to be a holding call against Chad Wiseman. But you can see the net off, and that was Weller taking Dustin Brown out of control, and they both took the net off its moorings.
So both teams are in double digits in power plays here, as this is the 10th of the game for Manchester. Grabeshka pressured by Jernander. Jernander steals the puck, centers one, and Ortmeier got held up by Lehu at the last second. Lehu in his own zone. He'll wind around behind the net. Yannick Lehu, second leading scorer in the AHL. Banks a pass toward Brown, but that's stopped by Nicolet, and he'll fire it back down.
Again, another bad pass by Yannick Lehu. That one had no chance of connecting.
Grabeshkov with a lead to Lehu. His cross-ice feed hits Halmanen. Now Camilleri has it go off his stick. Lampman pressured by Camilleri. The puck in skates. Nicolet can't work it free. Now finally he does, but he can't clear it past Grabeshkov. Camilleri to Kostopoulos. Now Lehu centers one, and Brown can only knock it wide. And Moore will break out. Might be a two-on-one with Halmanen. Moore and Halmanen. Only Grabeshkov is back. Moore shoots it. He put it wide. Rebound in front. What a save by Hauser on Moore. Halmanen still after. It's loose. Moore punches it toward the goal. And Hauser holds his ground again. And we've got a whistle and a stoppage in play. Holy smoke, the Wolfpack did everything but score there.
Oh, said Hauser something else. There's Moore going top shelf, bounces off. Look at that save, right pad by Hauser. Comes across, Hellman driving for it. Moore back in there. Great goaltending by Adam Hauser as he recovers right there. Wow. I'll tell you, he says, where's the puck? I found it.
I'm sure Hauser wasn't too happy with that Jernander goal, but he really redeemed himself there. That was a magnificent save.
I'll tell you, I can't tell you how disappointed I am in Yannick Lehu's passing tonight, because he made a bad play from behind the net that sprung that two-on-one.
Here's Gleason now for the Monarchs. Gets to the red line and fires in. Ryan lets it go through to Clark, now to Perros. Perros has a pass block. Ortmeier can't get to it. Good recovery by Perros. Now down comes Schmidt. He shoots. LaBarbera is there, and he'll cover up with Ryan crashing the crease. Down to a minute 34 on the game clock. 25 seconds in the penalty.
Now Chris Smith doing the big slapper off of the bounce off the boards, but that gives time for LaBarbera to get over there, and you're not going to beat him from there. He's just too big when he's squared with a shooter like that.
They're going to pull the goalie here, Brad. Get six attackers out for the last 25 seconds of the power play.
Yeah, it's 1:34, so they're going to have a 6-on-4 for 25. That'd be a 6-on-5. I kind of think when the penalty first happened, they're down a goal. I'd rather have two kicks at the cat, put a 6-on-4 for that full 2 minutes.
Ryan McGill likes to do that. Moore and Ryan on the faceoff. It goes to the corner. Now back to Gleason to Clark. Back to Gleason. He shoots. That deflects. And it's swept right through the crease. Played now by Nicolet. And he'll clear it up in the air. Not out. Nice keep by Chris Schmidt. Now once again, Nicolet stops the pass. Again, the Wolfpack can't clear. Now Clark works it toward the foot. Jams it on goal. LaBarbera makes the save. And he'll hold on. 2 seconds left in the penalty. A minute 10 in the third period.
Noah Clark trying to go cross ice, almost sneaks it between the legs of LaBarbera as he comes out of to the left of LaBarbera. And you're going to see right here as he picks the puck up. Now watch, this catches the right knee of Jason LaBarbera, almost sneaks through. I can see a little bit of action. Look at that traffic in front of the goaltender. When you get that many guys in front, that puck can't get to the net. I don't care. You know, you're stopping your own shots. You got to put one guy in there, two off to the side, because number one, if there's two guys in front, you're both facing. By the time you turn around, you're in each other's way.
Puck tied up behind the net. Penalty is over. Puck is loose. Camilleri shoots. That's blocked. Open net here. Oh, and Wiseman coughs it up. He can't get it out. Now Ortmeier blocks a try, and it's away to center ice. The Wolfpack with five players out there now with the penalty having expired. Lewis puck comes right in front of it. Hops over a Monarch stick. Great play near the line to keep it in by Gleason. Weller charging after it. He can't clear. Jernander tied up by Kostopoulos. Now Schmidt behind the goal. Perros goes falling, as does Weller. Schmidt holding the puck, throws it at the goal, and it deflects up and over the net into the netting. And out of play. Holy smoke, it looked like a fire drill out there, Brad.
There's lots of action. Looks like this faceoff's going to come outside.
That's a big break.
It made a big break for the Wolfpack as it went off of the thigh pad of one of the Monarchs and bounced up into the mesh above the net. Boy, I tell you, this is action. This is probably a very good time. I think that just before they drop the puck here, Ryan McGill's going to call a timeout, settle things down. Huh?
Bruce Boudreau's already used his timeout.
That's right. So the only timeout left is with the Wolfpack.
Lundmark and Lehoux on the draw. And Lehoux wins it. Over it goes to Brown. He has trouble with it. But now he's able to dump it in. Lampin. Pressured by Lehoux. Loose puck. Ballet. Uses the referee to run a little interference for him. But the Wolfpack can't clear. Now Lehoux throws a bad angle shot that goes off the side of the net. Lehoux holding and looking. Plays it over to the far side. Down to 9 seconds. Now pass is blocked by Nicolette. It comes to Brown. Brown throws it toward the front. Lundmark intercepts. Good play to protect the puck with his body. And it's away toward the line. That's going to be it. The Hartford Wolfpack are 2-0 against the league-leading Manchester Monarchs. They gut out a penalty-filled win. And Jason LaBarbera with another big game in net. His sixth straight win. He ties a franchise record of which he already holds a share.
An outstanding game for LaBarbera as he came through when needed. The Wolfpack struggled at times, especially late in this third period, but they did hold on for a sound earned victory. There's no doubt about that.
And there's the guy that had the game-winning goal, Ken Jernander, just his second of the year. His first was an empty netter. He really struggled to score goals this year, but I knew, Brad, that when he scored, it was going to be a big one, and it sure was here tonight.
Well, definitely. You got to credit the other guy on that line in the third period was Ryan Hallweg, who got a tying goal and also helped set up the winning goal by Jernander. And he found a screenshot that found the hole on Adam Hauser, making it 3-2 with about a little over 3 minutes to go in that third period. A big win for the Wolfpack.
Brad, thanks so much for your thoughts here tonight. Really appreciate all the insights. Brad Park, our color commentator here this evening. Next Saturday night at 7 o'clock, catch more Wolfpack action on MSG Network. We're in Hartford, hosts the Providence Bruins. Big win tonight for the Wolfpack over Bruce Boudreau and the Manchester Monarchs. 3-2 the final at the Hartford Civic Center. For Brad Park and our entire crew, I'm Bob Crawford, thanking you for watching and wishing you a very pleasant good night.